Resident Evil.
Hey guys, welcome back to a very end of Christmas episode, because it's 11:55 p.m. right now on Christmas. So yeah, happy holidays. Hope everybody had a terrible Christmas and a very bad coming into the new year. No, I'm kidding. I hope everybody had a good Christmas. I kind of wanted to do another episode. It's been a little while, so we are here tonight. And Richard, you know, he had to just, it's such a drag, you know, for him to be here. So
I'm actually tied up in a chair right now.
I'm holding him at gunpoint right now, actually.
And knife point. I literally have no other choice but to do this podcast right now.
It was like the last thing he really wanted to do on Christmas. He's like, family? Nah. Games? Nah. Podcast? Definitely so.
More like definitely nah, but that's when you jumped me.
Well, exactly. So I didn't actually hear that come out of your mouth. I stuffed your face with Christmas cookies, and we're here now.
They tasted like shit, by the way.
Mm-hmm. All right. So a lot of Resident Evil news kind of was happening for kind of sort of hit and miss.
Yeah.
We haven't really talked about anything because we wanted to kind of wait until, you know, I mean, because we could have, you know, we could have come up with stuff to talk about, kind of like our own, kind of our own topics, because that's easy to do. But around the time, like, you know, I think we last recorded in September. I think it was like early September or maybe late September. I don't know, something like that. And around that time, that's like when I started working and we all just became busy. So I figured we might as well just wait until it was time to do another podcast. And that was pretty much it. And now, you know, so there was news here and there. Like, I know that the Barry news kind of happened.
That was more recent.
I know that the gameplay was kind of shown. I
made fun of it. The TV show was announced.
That was kind of in the fall.
Well, it wasn't really announced. It was more like a rumor.
Yeah, it wasn't announced, but it was like kind of pitched in a sense. That happened in like October, so that was like right after we recorded. So we can. That's why I was like, all right, it's time to just record something. And also in January, because Richard has not played Remake yet, Remastered. Actually, he's never played Remake. He's lied, and it's not his favorite game of all time. No.
Yeah, it's a game that I bought, because you saw it in the
bought it.
But I've actually never played it.
You never played it. I
got stuck on the first zombie, and I couldn't get past it, so I labeled it as a shitty game.
You were doing a Let's Play of it for, like, 4 years?
Yeah, like, you know. I made, like, 50 parts all on the one zombie.
Yeah, like,
because I think it's a horrible game.
For Resident Evil, like, you have fans and you decided to,
I mean,
stretch
the Let's
out
Play on my channel, the Let's Play that was recorded, that was on me. That was my little brother who I don't really have, but I, for the sake of this conversation,
same,
I have a little brother.
He has
brother.
The same voice as you. Actually. He has,
well, no, I was commenting, but I forced him to play through it.
Okay.
I said,
did
do it now,
him
or
at
I'll.
Point, like I'm doing to you right now, to do.
I said, do it now, or I'll throw your Xbox out. Okay. And then he cried, and he did it.
Well, I mean, you know, the bills got to get paid, so you had to stretch it out, you know, to 50 parts.
Easy money.
Easy money part.
I'm not even a partner, but this will give me money.
Exactly, because I mean, you could just extend your hand, and money will just appear there, and.
Yeah, like John Carpenter.
John Carpenter extends his hand all the time, gets checks for stuff that he's not even a part of. So you weren't a part of that, and look at that. Now, what in January we're going to fully talk about the Resident Evil Remake Remaster, which is coming out January 20th. It was just announced that it's cross-buy, so if you buy it on PS3, you can upgrade for free on PS4 or vice versa for Xbox and Xbox One, which is cool.
Was it for Xbox?
Yes.
Well, on the article I read, they said PlayStation, but they didn't know about Xbox.
Yeah, no, it's coming out for Xbox. They officially, you can reserve it now on Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS4, blah, 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 and Steam.
I'm talking about the cross-buy.
Cross-buy is for everything, apparently. That's what Capcom tweeted. They said cross-buy across all consoles. That's what they said. So I hope that they are telling the truth on that, because usually when a company makes a game that's kind of like third-party cross-buy, it's pretty much for everything. But that was just announced because me and Perry talked about on our podcast, we were just like, we don't even think it's cross-buy. It was literally last week we were saying, I don't think it's cross-buy, and then they come out and say it's cross-buy, so that's kind of cool. But Richard and our friend JJ, who you know hasn't been on the show in a little bit, they both have yet to play it. So in January, when the time comes, and when I also play the PS4 version, because I've been playing my Japanese port, we can actually make a show of it, pretty much dedicated towards Remake, what we think of it and stuff. I myself can say, in a little bite-sized fashion, that I think it's fucking great. It's very fun. It feels great on the PlayStation controller. And it looks...
The PS3 controller.
The PS3 controller, yeah.
You have yet to try the PS4 controller.
Yeah, I've yet to try the PS4. I could actually plug it in.
Oh, that's right.
You can plug it in.
No vibration, though.
No vibration, but I mean, I mean, if you just wanted to get the sense of it. But I mean, hey, the only difference with the PS4 version or the One version...
60 frames?
No. Still 30.
Oh,
but,
really?
But, yeah, they're still 30. It's just 1080 versus 720, which makes slightly of a difference as far as resolution goes. But, I mean, the game already looks fantastic, so I think the fact that they're even upgrading it more kind of... it's just like, all right, you know, it's better. You can't complain. It's going to be great. I think people are going to love it. I want to stream it once I get this PS3, because I got an Elgato today and as planned, but it's not working as planned, so because I just have to get around the whole... First, I have to be able to record it. Then I got to be able to stream it. I hope I can stream soon, either by the end of December or within the new year. I will work on trying to get
the stream. I would focus on making some videos for your channel and then stream the PS4 version. If that's any easier, I don't know if that's... If that requires a splitter.
It doesn't. Well, that's the thing. I was thinking about doing a couple things that require my PS3, but I can't get it to, like, work right now. As far as Elgato, it works fine, but I have to fuck with it after the show and try to fix this, because right before, it just wasn't turning on. I don't know. It worked for 360. It worked for that. It worked for PS... Like, it's good, obviously. PS3, I don't know what's going on with something in the settings. It's probably something so easy. It's one of those things where it's so easy, and then you just didn't realize to change it. But as far as Remake goes, yeah, it's great. You guys saw my collection video on that. And I still also have to get the shelves put in, because I have to go to like Home Depot and tell them the dimensions, and they cut the wood shelf whatever dimensions I ask for, so I got to measure it out and just give them the dimensions length by width, and I got to put them in, but I don't know when that will be. Too lazy, but I have to get it done because I can't get anything else until I get that. So, well, I can, but I just can't put it on the shelf. But
in other news, Resident Evil.
Shut the fuck up, bitch. I'm talking about Resident Evil. I'm talking about Biohazard in Japan.
Bitch, no one cares about your shelf. Let's talk about some Resident Evil.
My shelf includes Resident Evil. Starting with the first one. The second one, no, I'm kidding. Alright, so the first batch of news since we've been gone. Since you've been gone.
Since you've been gone.
The Resident Evil TV show-ish thing. That was kind of the first thing that kind of came out, and I know a lot of people tweeted about it to me, and I took note, but I was just like, this would be interesting if it actually worked, but
yeah.
I'm going to pull up the article, because I feel like I'm going to forget it if I don't bring it up.
Sure.
But let me see here. And
I'm going to make a video about this eventually. Because this is something that I want to talk about on my channel as well.
Okay, so this was October 13th, 2014. Yep. So here we go.
There's a bunch of articles here.
Bunch of articles.
Which one are you reading?
I'm reading the one on Polygon.
Okay, same.
That was the first one.
Yeah.
It says, a televised series based on the Resident Evil film franchise is in the works, Variety reports. News of upcoming TV show was confirmed by studio executive Martin Moskowitz, whose German production house, Constantine Films, film is stepping up to into production of new TV release. The company is working on a number of film-to-TV spin-offs, including shows based on the book series The Mortal Instruments and Perfume. The production company aims to turn the Resident Evil franchise into a televised series following the release of the next feature film. Resident Evil, the final chapter, will be the last film released in a long-running franchise. Filming begins summer of 2015. So they're saying that they're trying to make it tie in with that, but I don't think...
Wait. I think they're just saying that they want to release it around the same time.
I don't think that's happening. We don't even have, like, solid material yet. But
no, it says franchise following the release of the next feature film. So after the movie comes out, they're going to do it, or they're going to release the TV series.
Well, I hope this is something that could happen, because I think it'd be kind of a really cool backstory if you get the right, like, people involved. I think you would have to, like, hire some people that are pretty diehard Resident Evil fans, because you need to know the backstory if you want to kind of do something of this nature, because it would either be set in the same universe. I think it'd be something cool where, like, they would do, like, kind of a early on into Umbrella's, like, creation, and then they can kind of do some stuff where, like, eventually we'll start seeing, like, other survivors during the Raccoon City, kind of from different perspectives, but done really well. I think that would be something really cool, but for some reason, I just don't see, like, them doing that. As much as a positive thing I would like this to be, I just hope that, like, you know, Resident Evil is very fragile as far as how it's used in for, like, the mass mainstream as far as movies go and entertainment, so it's kind of very easy to fuck up, I guess, but I mean, well, it's not, but people tend to make it seem like it's easy.
Well, here's the thing. No matter what we can hope for, they will make changes.
Mm-hmm.
So that's to be expected. I mean, they make changes with everything based on source materials. Like, you know, Game of Thrones has changes, for example. I know the TV series
S.D. Perry's books, they have changes. But
yeah,
they made changes. They're good.
For the most part.
For the most part, yeah.
Code Veronica had some really bad dialogue.
Yeah, Code Veronica did, yeah. I have to agree with you on that.
In the book, I mean, like, there's a scene where Wesker talks about, like, how Claire gives him a boner or something.
Yeah, I remember that.
And it was really bad. But they will make changes, hopefully for the better, you know?
Hopefully
the show will be more faithful to the games. I think this is a brilliant idea, to turn a game series into a TV series. I think this is excellent if they do it right.
Because
what they can do is they can concentrate on one season at a time, you know, 10 episodes each.
Yep.
And, you know, season 1 can be Resident Evil 1, season 2 can be Resident Evil 2, season 3 can be... Well, season 2 could be both 2 and 3, because it takes place during the same period.
Yeah, just kind of like every other episode's, like, from Leon and Claire.
Yeah, like, we'll switch between their perspectives.
That'd be so
Leon,
cool.
Leon, Claire, and Jill. And then season 3 can be Code Veronica, and season 4 can be Resident Evil 4. So there's a lot of possibility here. Like, I don't mind if they change some things, like you know, little things like, oh, Chris and Jill are in a relationship in the TV series. That wasn't in the games.
Yeah.
You know, if they do little things like that, I don't mind. But if they start making it where it's like, okay, we're going to center on this character who has nothing to do with the games, and she's going to go into an underground laboratory called The Hive, which has nothing to do with the games, and we're going to get supporting characters which have nothing to do with the games.
Yeah, and it's like what Richard said, is that there's a lot of possibilities with this, And the thing is, when you kind of, like, take this idea and you're like, okay, we don't have to rush this into an hour and a half film or an hour 40-minute film. We can take the time to develop characters each week
with
or whatever.
10 episodes, you have a lot more screen time.
Exactly.
And that's what I love about it. It doesn't have to be, you know, an hour and a half to 2 hours.
Exactly.
You can put so much screen time into a 10-episode season.
It's funny that you bring this up because that now I haven't seen it yet, but I've heard that show Gotham is pretty good, and it's kind of like each individual episode's focused on like a certain villain or it has a lot of like development behind a lot of stuff, kind of like, you know, what you wouldn't normally get in a just a, you know,
in a regular movie.
So seeing stuff like that are as recent, you know, and that has a lot of pacing. It's not rushed. It's not like, okay, we have to have these like flashy action scenes because we got to keep these people interested. It's like, no, same thing in Walking Dead. A lot of people complain, oh, like they talk a lot. It's like, it's
they
for
talk
a reason.
A lot.
Like, it's for a reason. You know what I mean? You don't want zombie killing every fucking like second. It's not what it is. Like, it's not.
Yeah, like that's very boring to me. If they were to make it just, you know, nonstop action,
it's like if
non-stop.
I wanted to watch that, I'd watch a movie. But The Walking Dead is supposed to be a show with thought-out characters, and Game of Thrones is the same way from what I've heard from people. It's True Blood was the same way on HBO. So it's just like there's slower scenes for a reason, and I think if they took this idea with Resident Evil, they took the time, they wrote this out, and think about it. With, like, a show, and if, like, let's say a show gets criticism, they can always kind of, like, adjust things as far as, like, you're waiting for, like, this movie that's just going to happen once, it doesn't do good, and they just never make it again, and you're just left like, what the fuck? I just feel like it's in a much more, how should I put this? It has more freedom to
and
be itself.
Each episode, you can do, like you said, you have a lot more freedom with each episode.
Yes, yeah.
But you also, like, you know, you have an hour to work with.
Yeah.
So you can concentrate on that 1 hour and make it as awesome as you can. And, you know, I'm picturing it right now. Episode 1, it can be the STARS members at head office, and it could just be them doing their, you know, doing their whatever, their daily routine, drinking coffee, having small talk. And then as the episode goes on, they find out about Bravo Team, and, you know, episode 1 can end with them running into the mansion, and that would be a good cliffhanger for episode 2. They have, you know, with 60 minutes, you can make it as awesome as you can because it's not too long, but once you take all the episodes together, you know,
it
adds a lot more than an hour and a half movie can do.
Dude, you know how cool it would be to fucking see that police station, like, recreated as is, if not, like, similar?
Dude, because like, you know how in the game, you know in Resident Evil 2, like, you walk into one of the rooms and you find a note by Martin?
Yes, yeah.
And he's like, oh, there are these new things called lickers. That's what people are calling them. And, you know, the zombies have kind of outnumbered us and stuff. It's like, we can see that in a TV show.
I know, they just...
We can see how those scenes went down.
I know, that would be so cool. That's why I think they need to get these people in here that, like, know...
Sorry, was it Marvin or Martin? Marvin, right?
I think it was Marvin, yeah.
Okay, I said Martin.
That's,
yeah.
It's all good. I pretty much knew what you were talking about. But, Will Smith. Like, if they got... Will Smith. If they got, like, you know, the right people to get on this and were just like, you know, like if for example, like if me and you were people that were in the industry and we got this job, like we would eat it up because we're like, okay, we're gonna add this and this. I hope that happens to somebody on the opposite side of the spectrum where they're just like, okay.
Yeah, I hope this project is given to someone who actually cares about the games. And I hope it's not taken over by studios and stuff like that, because we know what can happen when they meddle, and I hate it when they meddle, but if people treat this with the right amount of seriousness and the right amount of fun, you know, Resident Evil is not supposed to be too serious. It's a B-movie series, but don't make it cheap-looking. You know, give it the care that it deserves. Make it fun and scary.
Make it like the movies were supposed to be, you know? I mean...
Yeah, like, Afterlife has a high budget, but it's also very cheapish at the same time.
As far as writing and trying to just rush everything.
Yeah, like, if you're looking to get into writing or directing and you want some good movies to study, Afterlife is one of the movies that you should avoid. Because that's not a good example of a good movie. It's fun. It's one of my guilty pleasures, but it's not a good movie by any stretch of the imagination. Because it's just so... The budget was there for the visuals, but it felt very cheap at the same time. You know, an episode of Game of Thrones costs $6 million to make, and that's far more convincing than any Resident Evil movie. And just an example that a low budget can be used very wisely.
And the thing is that, you know, what you brought up was, like, you know, the films, as successful as they are, I just wish that, like, you know, when that studio or whoever actually kind of sits down and whenever they get the green light for this and they actually have material to go off of, I just hope that nobody looks at the movies and are just like, all right, well, this made a lot of money, so if we did this on a show, we'd get ratings, blah, blah, blah. It's just, I don't want it to be doomed from the start, and obviously we won't know until they give us details like, okay, we're really focused for the first season, we're really focusing on this detail. And all of us, like, hardcore fans will be like, oh my God, that's awesome. You know, a lot of, obviously, cash people won't pick up on that. So that's fine. But that's why I think that it's cool, because if they did that and people kind of go back and they're like, oh, cool, like, so this actually happened in the game and this happened, so they can kind of, like, pick up on stuff without even playing the game.
People like me and you would make comparison videos.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, we could be like, okay, this the TV show versus the games, this is what, you know, was from the games.
Mm-hmm.
One thing that I do worry about is, here's an example of another TV show. It's called Legend of the Seeker. You probably never heard of it.
I have not.
It was produced by Sam Raimi. Okay, ooh. We all know who Sam Raimi is.
No,
Legend of the Seeker is a TV show that was based off of a book series called Sword of Truth. It's a fantasy series. The first book, which is the only one I've read, it's really good. It was translated into that series, Legend of the Seeker, and after I read the book, I watched some of the episodes, and I was like, this is terrible. This is really bad. It feels so cheap, and they changed a lot of things as well. Like, they kept the same basic story, but they changed so much of the things in the book that made it, like, you know, really good.
Yeah.
And that's something that I hope they don't do with Resident Evil. I think, you know, it's okay to change small things, like, oh, maybe make these two characters in a relationship, change up some of the minor backstories, or add more backstory that was mentioned in the games. But don't make the show, like I said, like, you know, cheesy and cheap and just awful and cringeworthy. Because nobody wants to watch that. If you do make it like that, it'll end up like Legend of the Seeker, where it was canceled after season 2. And if they treat this with the right amount of passion and the right budget, you know, this can go on to season 8.
Yeah.
Okay, so, like, some TV shows, Spectacular Spider-Man, which is an amazing TV show, that was canceled after season 2.
Because of production issues and creative differences.
Because the rights were reverted back to Marvel, the TV show rights. So Sony, which, you know, made Spectacular Spider-Man, they couldn't continue it. They were forced to cancel it. And I think they also mentioned that they were also relying on DVD sales, which obviously no one bought. They did release Spectacular Spider-Man as a complete series on Blu-ray.
I still need to pick up.
It's amazing. I picked it up back in June. It's one of the best cartoons you'll ever see. But the thing I hate about it is that it ends on a cliffhanger. So it's always a bittersweet experience watching
that. Why do the best Spider-Man cartoons, the two best ones, end on a cliffhanger?
I don't know, dude.
Because it was set up. It was supposed to continue.
The 90s series still had another...
But we got cock-blocked. By the studios. Like,
and I hope that doesn't happen with this. Like, I want the series, if it's good, I want the series to keep going. Look at Game of Thrones, right? Each season is so successful because everyone loves it. You know, second highest rated TV show on IMDb. And I can see why that is.
What's the first?
Breaking Bad.
Okay.
Which was also really amazing.
Still haven't watched that. I wish I could watch all these. I just burned Game of Thrones 1 through 3 for my friend Kyle's, his parents. They wanted to check it out, and Kyle was not spending that much money on every fucking season, so
I spent the money, because like, I recently got into it. I was like, let me just check out season 1, and I bought it on Blu-ray. Mm-hmm. And then I bought seasons 2 and 3 on Blu-ray, because the show is just amazing.
Well, my thing is that I have them on my hard drive still, so I might have to get around to watching it if I get some free time soon.
Dude, watch the first 10 minutes of episode 1. If you don't get hooked, I'm going to slap you. I'm going to mollywop you.
All right, well, okay. Maybe by the next episode of the podcast, we'll be able to.
The reason I'm bringing up Game of Thrones is because it's just,
well, yeah, you want to compare it to shows that work.
Shows that work. Like Breaking Bad was like 6 seasons long.
Because we're talking about these shows that have been either been on for a long time or are still going, like Game of Thrones and whatnot, Walking Dead. Yeah.
Breaking Bad, that was in 2008.
Yeah.
That started. It ended in 2013. And you know what's so beautiful about Breaking Bad?
What's that?
They gave it a good conclusion.
Hmm.
It did not end on a cliffhanger. They ended it.
They tied all loose ends.
They tied all loose ends. It was amazing. I think season 4 was like the best season. And it was great. They're doing a spinoff series called Better Call Saul.
Is that your favorite show as of right now, or is Game of Thrones kind of...
My favorite show is Game of Thrones. Breaking Bad is my second favorite.
I feel so left out, because all my friends are also watching it, and they're just like, dude, season 4 is coming on, or you gotta catch up, you have time.
Yeah.
Like, same thing with X-Files. I started it, and I still got to finish it. X-Files is obviously much longer, but again...
Well, on Canadian Netflix, at least, it's probably the same for American.
Mm.
We have every episode of Breaking Bad.
Okay. I think we do.
You can binge-watch that if you want.
I might.
Basically, just, take a week off and watch all the episodes. It is really good, and I don't say that lightly.
Mm. If we're able to say this about a Resident Evil show, that would make us fucking happy. I mean, imagine us doing, like, weekly discussions about the episode.
On, like, each episode, yeah.
That would be like that, sick. That would be so cool,
But it's like these shows, right? Breaking Bad, Game of Thrones, they're not... I mean, in terms of TV, they're pretty expensive, I guess. But the reason that they can do such expensive episodes, for each season is because they're so damn successful.
And the studio behind it's willing to back it and put enough money into it. Not like Walking Dead, where AMC treats everybody like shit.
Where they fired, the creator and they cut the budget in half.
Yeah, keep its baby. Yeah. And, like, pretty much, like, fucking say fuck you.
That's fucked up.
Yeah, AMC's fucked up. And it's a shame, because imagine if, like, Walking Dead was on something like HBO. Imagine, like, how much more freedom they would have. Like,
season 2 of Walking Dead was originally going to be so much different. It wasn't even going to be on the farm. It was supposed to deal with the dead guy in the tank.
Yeah,
you remember that?
Yes, I remember that now, especially watching, YMS, his fucking shit.
Yeah.
He does pretty good independent research, which is why I respect him a lot as a YouTuber. Because he does a lot of shit on his own and he's not like biased or, Twin Perfect. but it's like, that's why, because I heard about that when it happened, when they let him go. I was just like, why, that's, he became friends with everybody, blah, blah, blah. And then I watched his video and, you kind of learn more about it and you kind of see it through different perspective.
And he was like, showing interviews from...
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know the actor's name. I call him Starkiller because that's who he played in the Force Unleashed games. But Starkiller's just like, season 2 was going to be completely different, and then they just fucked him over, basically.
Yeah,
and he wasn't sugarcoating it. you know? Yeah, it really shed some light on how shitty studios can be.
And that's what I'm saying, is that, like, whoever backs this show and actually has faith in it, I just hope they don't kind of pull the rug from underneath their feet, so to speak, where it's like, okay, you got this solid thing to walk on, and then we're just gonna, like, okay, we see something we don't like, or we don't want to give you enough money, fuck you, yeah, you're going down with everybody else. And it's just,
well, it's weird
fair.
Because I think AMC is also behind Breaking Bad.
Very true, yeah.
But I don't know what happened with, because they didn't fuck over Breaking Bad.
No, they didn't. I guess it just, creative minds just work differently. So whoever,
maybe it's like a different team working on Breaking Bad. I don't know.
Different people maybe looked at it as like, okay, this is gonna be the next big thing. We have to like do something completely different. Now, all right. Well, here's the thing about Walking Dead, and it's all relevant to the conversation. I thought season two was okay for what it was. Obviously, it being different. I thought it developed a lot of the characters. I thought Shane was pretty cool to see unravel.
Yeah.
I liked his character. As much people hated him, he was kind of like how Rick is now in the current state of the world of The Walking Dead. And I'm not going to spoil anything for people who haven't seen it.
From what I've gathered, though, most of the people who hate on Walking Dead, they hate it because they think the series doesn't really go anywhere. They always seem to complain that each episode just centers on the characters moping around and talking instead of actually doing something. I don't know. I mean, I think the talking's kind of entertaining because the acting is really good.
Because they're talking about the situation. They're not just
Walking Dead is, you know, I don't hold it as one of the best TV shows ever made, but it's enjoyable.
Yeah.
Only stupid thing that I recall from season two is when they try to get the zombie out of the well without killing it, or no, without spilling blood.
Yeah,
because it's like, you're seriously going to drink that water after that fat zombie's been in there? No.
Yeah, I wouldn't even,
that was stupid
at that point.
Yeah, that was stupid. But you know, the scene with Shane in the barn, and when he was shooting the zombies and he was like, you know, talking to Herschel, and he's like, oh, did that, I don't remember what he said.
Yeah, he was like, do normal people recover from this? And
yeah.
Like, shot. Yeah. Yeah, like,
he's like, you call that normal?
Yeah, like, you call
and
that normal.
And he was
normal.
Trying to make
a
point.
People still, like, you know, can be, like,
and then you see
around.
Sophia coming out of the barn.
Yeah, and then Rick just steps up. He's just like, poof. Like, the thing is that the way I see it, is, you know, same thing with what they could do with this show when it happens, or if it happens, I hope. It's like, when Walking Dead, obviously, it establishes a lot of things. I think the weakest season is season three. I didn't... It was an okay season, but it was...
I remember that one dragging as it went
it was,
on.
That one was dragging.
With Andrea, like, I just... I hated Andrea.
And I didn't like how... what they did with the governor, and like I thought season four was much more fast paced and was like, okay, we gotta fucking, you know, do this right. And the season right now, it's good. The mid season finale wrapped up what was it, like late November? Yeah, it was like November or first week of December or something. And you know, it's coming back in March. I think it's good. It's the only show that I'm watching right now, you know, that like I'm keeping up to date with. Obviously, within that time, hopefully I can start watching like Game of Thrones, some more X-Files. But
it's funny though, because you know, you mentioned HBO.
Yeah.
HBO does Game of Thrones, they do True Blood.
Mm-hmm.
And there's so much nudity in Game of Thrones.
Oh, yeah.
Like there's so much blood and gore, so much violence, and it's like so much coarse language. Like, I think with Breaking Bad, the writers were allowed to say fuck once per season. So when they do say fuck in Breaking Bad, it has a lot of power to it.
Mm.
And there's a really good scene with Walter and a character named Gretchen, and they're sitting at dinner, and you know, Walter says the F word. And it was like, wow, like that was really, you know, intense and dramatic.
Mm-hmm. It goes with the
But
same.
Then in Game of Thrones, it's like they say fuck a lot. Like they say fuck like 10 times an episode.
Yeah, I know.
And it's like how does HBO get away with this?
They don't care. Same thing. Entourage was another show that was on HBO, and that
I heard Rome was another one that, which was HBO as well. That one had a lot of violence in it.
True Blood recently ended officially, and you know, it wrapped up after. I followed that show since 2008, September of 2008. Since literally, I watched the premiere that night on Sunday. It would come on every Sunday. Same thing like Game of Thrones. And it was HBO's like highest rated show, obviously, but obviously Game of Thrones came way later. But you know, they had some problems with writing too. I think it had some slow parts. But True Blood again is kind of like the same way, where it's like there's no boundaries. Like, it's vampires. Obviously, vampires have a very sexual thing about them. You know, they're
very seductive.
Very seductive. So they showed pretty much everything you could think of, and vampires getting staked, like, while fucking. I mean, like, shit like that. It's like, it's insane.
Yeah.
So, like, that's what I would like to see, you know, in a Resident Evil thing, where it's like, it doesn't have to be on HBO, but I definitely want to see them, like, do
what
they
have
to. I would
want HBO to handle it.
If HBO handled it, I mean, that would be
amazing. If HBO gets this, and I don't think it will be HBO, I think they did mention a studio in one of these articles, I forget. It was some studio that I never heard of before. I don't know which article it was. I can try and find it, but I know that HBO would, depending on how much they take it seriously, like, they would give it the care that it deserves. Like, they would give it the right amount of violence and the right budget and stuff. I mean, Rome, that series got canceled after season 2 because they overspent on it. They were like, okay, this is getting way too expensive. We gotta shut this thing down.
I was
now.
Like, shit, have money.
It was good though. Like, from what I've heard, people thought it was great.
But it just got again cock blocked by studio problems.
With Game of Thrones, I think that's the most expensive TV show on right now.
And they got the money to do it,
dude. There are scenes in Game of Thrones where I'm like, okay, that looks better than movies that come out today. Because I think what they do is, I could be wrong on this, but I think they use paintings as background sometimes. They did the same thing in John Carpenter's The Thing when when RJ's looking over the hill and they see the UFO. And it's like, oh, okay, so that actually looks kind of convincing. But it's a simple way of building a world without spending too much. You know, not everything has to be like green screen. And most of the effects in Game of Thrones are practical.
That's something you don't get a lot now. A lot of it's CG.
That's something that the live-action Resident Evil movies do a lot. Like, I think Afterlife is like 90% green screen. If you go and watch that movie.
Yeah, that is.
If it was a TV show, I would want them to find a mansion, decorate it, you know, get everyone under prosthetics, get the zombie dogs, you know, get the weapons and everything. Mm-hmm. You don't need a green screen to make it convincing.
And that's why I think, like, you know, when we bring up kind of all these factors that kind of make a good show, I think that if they were to take this in a direction where, okay, like, we have this hour to work with, we got, you know, we have to make this just be very grounded and very real, it's like, I could see it happening. I'm worried, but I'm excited at the same time. So it's kind of one of those things where you really just have to, you know, just hope that whoever steps behind this just takes an account of, like, look at shows that worked in the past, you know, or that are working currently, and just kind of see, you know, obviously you might have limitations because of networks and what channel it's airing on. I get that, you know, but, you know, I mean, hell, I mean, I know there's shows that are just Netflix exclusives, you know, Green Arrow or like The Flash show, I think, is on Netflix or something. It's just,
no, those aren't exclusives to Netflix, but
okay.
No.
Well,
I think House of Cards is.
That's probably the best show I've ever seen. No, they have, like, you know, these things that they can do right. I think they really should just figure it out as far as, like, what they're going to do for, like, pitch some ideas, or just, like, start giving us information, just seeing how we respond, because I think that's how they should do it. I feel like with, like, the Resident Evil films, they just, like, They just kind of
If they start doing that, then every fan is going to start giving them different ideas of what they think the series should be. You know what I mean?
It's true, but I feel like, well, I've not really, well, how should I put this? Not so much where it's like asking, like, us to give them stuff, but just for them to just kind of like tell them what they're going to, tell us what they're going to do. And, you know, hopefully we just, you know, we'll actually like it. Because obviously everybody's going to have their own ideas of how things should be done. And, you know, if you're a fan, you kind of can't help it. But I think it'll be cool, like, if we just get some more out of it. We kind of see where they want to, like, go.
It would be cool to see the progress of it, you know?
Yeah.
Not just them hiding it until they announce it, and then they give us something we don't like.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's like, once I know it gets
greenlit. It's like, yeah, like let us, or shed some light on how you're going to do this. But as far as specific ideas go, I think that's all on them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying, make it more faithful. It'll be far more enjoyable that way, and make it as good as you can make it.
Yeah.
Like, treat it with passion, with seriousness. Don't make a shitty, cheap TV show like Legend of the Seeker.
Yeah, and like, you know, once it gets greenlit, that's when they can actually start throwing out some material. So, you know, if, you know, fans can make, you know, better shit than the movies, you know, as far as like YouTube and stuff, I mean, I'm sure that if they took the time.
Do you remember that one fan trailer?
Yeah, we talked about that.
It was about like them in the mansion.
Yeah, we talked about that on the show. It was probably like episode 5. You know, it was a while ago.
Yeah. Like that one was, it looked cheap. Okay. It looked cheap, but it looked like it had a far more interesting premise and a far more interesting atmosphere.
Yeah, it's like a fan film. It's a fan film.
But if you have that budget and you do something like that, it's going to be great.
Yeah. And hey, you might have network limitations, but look at Walking Dead. I mean, they got limitations because they were stuck at a TVMA, but you know, they've done a lot of, you know, nasty shit on that show. So it's like you can work around it.
Yeah, like Walking Dead, you know, Game of Thrones, Breaking Bad, they have a lot of gore in them.
Mm-hmm.
There's a scene in Breaking Bad, I'm not going to say, you know, what happens, but a character kind of, like, becomes the victim of an explosion, and you see the aftermath, and it's like, and they mention it in the Never Sleep Again documentary. Like, I remember them bringing up TV shows and movies, and they were saying how, you know, they've been getting more violent over the years, and they showed that clip of Breaking Bad.
I must not remember that, though. I definitely...
Or did they?
I
know they did show a clip from Breaking Bad, but maybe it was a different scene.
I'm not sure, but, I mean... But yeah, another thing is like Greg Nicotero, who does amazing makeup. You know, he does that shit for Walking Dead. That stuff looks great.
Yeah,
it looks because it's, you know, he's like, he's from that era of practical effects.
The studios behind Walking Dead might, you know, fuck over the cast and crew and story decisions. But one thing that The Walking Dead does right is prosthetics.
Mm-hmm.
It does look very good.
Yeah, they have a great makeup team behind them.
Yeah,
great walkers, and like as the seasons go on, the walkers look more and more decayed. Like, this isn't spoiling anything, but let's just say that there's a really cool scene where somebody gets in a fire truck and literally has like the you know how they have the hoses on top, literally just like sprays zombies, and like they literally just fall apart instantly from the pressure. Like, it's really
cool. Because they've been rotting for so long.
They're rotting for, and like, this shit like that, it's just like, you don't really get to really see that progression in a film. Like, you can, but like, it doesn't develop very long. So, all in all, I mean, they can really, you know, they can really just do a number on, like, this, like, in a good way. They can just kind of, like, go all out and be like, alright, we're gonna do this the way we want to do it. We're gonna follow, you know, what we want to do from the games, not necessarily taking all these directions from studio heads and what makes more money, what gets more views. I mean, if it falters, then at least they tried. At least we got to see something. But, I mean, I wouldn't mind, you know, seeing it. And I had my doubts at first because I know how they work with stuff like this, especially Capcom. But, I mean, just I really want to see this green. I want to see something about this in 2015. Show us a green light. Show us that some material is being written. Ideas and actors and whatnot are being, in, you know, thought about and kind of,
you know, they're dying. Game of Thrones looks a lot like Blood.
Really?
Yeah. The more questionable characters. Wait, hold on. Let me see if I can get a picture.
I gotta see this.
Cause as a, like in season 3 especially, like he looks like Leon, but with a beard. Okay. Here's one example.
I gotta see this. Hang on.
Isn't that Leon with the beard?
Damn, that is. Shit. If you guys know who we're talking about, you'll know. Oh, man.
For people who have seen the show, we're talking about the Kingslayer, but without giving anything away.
Wow. That's pretty funny.
It's fucking Leon. Here's another one, dude. It's Leon S. Kennedy.
Give that motherfucker a fur coat. And throw him in the fucking
RPD. Give him the fucking RPD outfit.
Give him the RPD.
For season 2.
Wow, that does look like... Oh, wow. Hey, it looks 10 times better than what we got in fucking... what was it? Retribution?
Fucking porn actor in Resident Evil cosplay.
Oh, God.
I lost a lot of friends today. I have no emotion. A guy got chainsawed in front of you, dude. You don't even care.
I lost a lot of friends.
He's just there to, like, follow Alice in that movie. Mm. He has no purpose.
Or just to be like, hey, I'm Leon. I'm finally in these movies. Hi.
And then Barry dies. It's like...
Flips the Magnum. That was, like, the dumbest fucking thing I've probably ever seen in a film. He does
the thing that Claire did.
Yeah, like... What the hell is this? Like, I saw that and I just kind of, like, smiled and shook my head in disappointment, but smiled because it's so fucking bad. Like...
Again, I couldn't stop laughing during the final fight when Rain hits Alice.
Yeah.
And Alice is like, ooh!
That was a good fight scene, though.
Oh, yeah, with the bones and shit. I remember now.
I thought that was pretty good.
The x-ray. I thought it was stupid, but it could have been... The concept of the Mortal Kombat bones would have made the fight even better if it was a good fight. Like, if you actually cared.
Hmm. Well, I didn't care. I just like seeing them kick the shit out of each other.
But imagine, like, if you actually do care about the characters, it would be a lot more than just watching them kick the shit out of each other.
You're kind of, like, you're invested in them. Get hurt. And these are characters that you're invested in and whatnot. Kind of like how in the games, like, you know, like when, you know, like when Jill gets infected in the third one, you know, she's has the virus and you have to go make it, like, you know, she's in dire need of medical attention. It's like, you kind of care about that because there's...
Well, something interesting characters. That, you know, Game of Thrones does is that you'll see the perspectives from the heroes and the villains.
Okay.
But then you kind of get a sense... You know, as to where they're coming from.
Now,
so when a hero and a villain fight each other in that show, you're kind of rooting for both of them because you like both of them. Because
it developed both sides.
Yeah, because they took the time to develop their characters.
Now,
and when people get in a fight in that show, you know shit's gonna go down, and you know, like, this isn't gonna end well, and you don't want it to you know, be bad for any of the characters, but it gives the show more weight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's funny you bring it up, because I've seen one episode of that show, and I was over at my friend's house, and obviously they knew the show, and I was like, all right, like, I'll watch it, and it was, I don't know the characters' names, but it was just somebody's, like, skull got, like, crushed or something, I don't know.
When was this?
This was...
Was it this past year? Like, was it 2014?
I don't think...
Or was it 2013?
It might have been 2013, I don't know.
Because I haven't seen Season 4 yet. I'm waiting for the Blu-ray. But I don't remember Skull getting crushed.
Well, then if you didn't see it, then it doesn't matter because I don't know the character's name. But I saw, like, a... It was one of those things where, like you said, there was kind of, like, the good and the bad. And it was, like, you thought the person won, but then, like, he just gets up and just goes, like, hyah! Like, I was like, whoa, that looks cool. And then I just never watched the show, but I have to still, so.
There's a scene where one of the characters, he's called the Mountain, he loses a jousting match, so he gets off his horse and he decapitates it with one swing. Because he's so fucking pissed off. He's like, ah! And you see the horse's head, like, get sliced off.
That's great.
And there's just a lot of those, like, really cool moments.
Like, stuff like that I appreciate, because it's, like, it's so, like, fake, but it's funny. You know what I mean? Like, it's real. Like, you know it's fake, but it's, like,
yeah.
It looks really intense and glorified.
And well, you know, like, Leon's character, the one I just sent you.
Yeah.
His nickname is called the Kingslayer. I'm not going to, you know, give anything away, but in season one, you know, they make him really despicable. You hate him. But then in season three, they kind of flip the tables around and you start to feel very sorry for him. And then he gives you, like, his version of the story or of, you know, the events of in his life. So, like, in season one, it's like, okay, I do not like you. But then in season three, it's like, holy shit, do not die on me.
Yeah.
So, I'm hoping, like, you know, they take the time to take their characters seriously in this TV show. Even though they're very silly characters in the game sometimes, like Alfred, you know, Irving, very silly moments. Don't, you know, don't half-ass it, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, and like, a thing that I like about, you know, what, like I said, kind of like what shows are starting to do, is, you know, for a while there, I think it's like shows are starting to just take the spotlight again versus movies, where for a while there, you know, you kind of were getting a lot of these really great films, and then it's like shows are starting to kind of take over. Which is good, because I feel like they can get a lot more done, like we were saying, you know, with the production and whatnot and what you can do in each week. So it's kind of funny watching this cycle kind of, you know, turn around. And that's maybe that's why people were like, all right, well, the movies are pretty much done. Let's see what we can do about the show. It kind of makes sense. If shows are in right now and not so much these blockbuster grab everything opening weekend films, I like that, because, you know, you can take note from good shows, like we've been talking
about. The funny thing is that this movie series has been going on since 2002.
Yes.
They're still not fucking done.
And we're done high school.
And the game, and the, you know, one season, which can be done in a year, that will be longer than the movie series.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And I think we've even talked about that on our movie episode, that we talked about all the films, of just like how long it's actually been since we've been seeing the same thing. I mean, it's the longest running video game movies of all time. And it probably will honestly stay that way, because I don't think anybody else has the balls to keep fucking doing it. So, I mean, like I said, if TV shows are in, then I just really hope they just fucking say, screw it, we're gonna do what's right. And you know,
I prefer a good TV show over a good movie, because if it's good and you're invested in what's going on, it lasts a lot longer,
and it's like you're living with the characters, like you're kind of,
yeah, like you go to the store, you pay $50, okay, that's a lot, 50 bones, but you come home and yet 10 hours worth of entertainment just from that one season alone.
Yeah.
So
exactly,
it's like it's cool. You get your money's worth, and it becomes a lot more enjoyable at the end of the day.
And a lot of the things that, you know, we were mentioning before, it is just, it's really something where it's like, it's just not that hard to do. It's just not that hard to do. I just hope that whoever gets...
It's not that hard to write it and come up with the concept.
Yeah.
Well, writing's very hard. Who am I kidding? But if you... You know, it's not that hard to kind of make it faithful to the game.
That's pretty much what I'm saying, yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to get everything right when you're making it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Because they can have, like, the best concept ever, but what if they decide to pick some shitty mansion that doesn't even...
Or we get bad actors, or...
Or we get bad... Yeah, bad actors. Yeah. Only me. Only me.
We get actors. Yeah.
Actors. But, would you like some fries with that? Let's talk Resident Evil.
Episode 15. They can actually really get this going. Like I said, I'm very excited to see what comes from this. I hope it's just not like kind of like a one article thing and then we see like it just slowly fades out, like several video game movie concepts or like Last of Us, yeah, for example, which is, I guess, is still in development.
Hopefully it won't just last one season and then end with a cliffhanger on Raccoon City.
Yeah, exactly.
That's another thing. If they should make it as if each season is their last, but also make it open for future seasons.
Exactly.
So, like, you know, end it with Chris and Jill and Barry flying off in the and Rebecca flying off in the helicopter. You get a nice happy ending, closure, loose ends are tied up, and if it's successful, great, you can do season two. But if they end it on a cliffhanger and they cancel the show, it's like, well, every time we watch it, we're going to be like, where's our closure? Mm-hmm. It's like Spider-Man 3 or Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Yeah. You'll never get it, and it's just like it wasn't supposed to be like that, you know. It's like, oh, they're gonna introduce this person, oh, they're gonna do this, they're gonna do so, you know. There's a lot of cool ideas, and I guess we'll just see what happens. If anything, we will obviously report on it, and you know, hopefully we get to see some something as far as like stuff's being written or somebody interviews somebody about it and they get to tell us, you know, stuff. Because some things can, like, be official. Like, same thing with, like, the Last of Us film, which was, like, had a panel and Sam Raimi, and they're looking at that girl from Game of Thrones to be Ellie.
Maisie Williams. Yeah. She plays a girl named Arya.
Yeah.
And while I was watching Game of Thrones, because I saw that panel, and while I was watching Game of Thrones, I was like, you know, she would make a perfect Ellie.
I have not seen her in action yet, so I'm not going to say anything until I see it, but I'll take your word for it.
Especially in season 3, dude. Like, that's British Ellie.
Yeah, and you know, when we mentioned, like, Last of Us, it's like, you know, it's a film that, like, okay, we got these people, but it's like, it's either it really gets made or it just doesn't, because a lot of things have been greenlit and then just never seen the light of day. So I just hope that that goes over well as a Resident Evil TV show. But as far as, like, you know, what we're going to see, when we're going to see it, I don't know. But we're getting a lot more stuff, I guess, in the meantime for Resident Evil, so to speak. But, I mean,
it won't be until 2016.
Definitely. I think...
Because if the next movie comes out at the end of 2016... We might not get a TV show until 2017.
Yeah, and like...
So it'll be a while.
It'll be a little while, unless they, you know, decide, like, okay, we're going to just, you know, start working on some stuff as they kind of, like, release it, and we might get it around the same time. I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do, but I feel like I'm very excited to see it unravel. Hopefully we get to see some good stuff soon. You know, and that's
fine. If this turns out well, then I'll be very excited for it.
Yeah. And the fact that we could do, like, weekly discussions about it would pretty much not only get us excited, but I'm sure the people that are listening excited as well. So, you know, you just kind of put everything together and it kind of works out. So I hope it happens. I guess we're going to have to wait and see. But you'll stay updated, so, I mean, we'll keep everybody updated with what's going on. Probably you guys will find out before us, or we'll find out, and we'll just have to wait to kind of do this, because, I mean, it's a couple months old, but, like, you know, we're finally able to, like, you know, talk about it. Like, we're an hour in right now, so, you know, we talked about that for an hour. So it's cool that we're able to, you know, kind of do that still. Especially because, like, with news kind of being slow, that was kind of like, oh, okay, that's different. You know, it's not game, you know, Capcom game related. It's just kind of like,
this is
different. Like, you know, like, this is something that I didn't expect. I didn't expect to see an arc about a fucking show. That was the last thing that I was expecting. Cause I remember being out, I think I was like, I forget where I was, and like somebody tweeted me that, and
I got a post on my Facebook about it.
Yeah, and so I was just like, wow, this is cool. And then, you know, here we are finally talking about it. But I mean, let us know what you guys think of the show, or like kind of what you would want to see maybe. And let us know if you're excited about it. But as far as gaming is concerned, the Resident Evil games, we got a couple stuff.
Ooh.
That kind of popped up every sometime. I kind of made fun of the running in something. I
agree with that. 100% all the way.
So Revelations 2 is in the spotlight, disregarding Remake Remastered, which, again, we'll all talk about that pretty much a month from now, because it comes out the 20th of January, so...
If you guys want our quick thoughts on it, which we probably already know, but I'm looking forward to it. I'm sure it'll be great seeing my favorite game updated in nice, crisp HD. Mm-hmm. Getting those trophies, playing the game over and over again, like I did on GameCube. It'll be fun.
Yeah, and we'll go all in depth, and we'll get JJ in here, and we'll have a fucking threesome of discussion. So... With Resident Evil Revelations 2, which is on the floor right now, it's coming out in kind of like an episode format, which a lot of people wanted us to talk about that too. I don't know if we even did before. I don't remember.
What we talk? What?
How they're releasing it in like an episodic format or episodic?
Oh, however you did we talk about that? I don't
remember, because I don't remember when we they might announced have. This shit. I mean,
I don't think we did, actually.
Well. It's starting in February 17th or something weird like that. No. It starts the beginning of February, and then I think it's like it goes into March, and then I think like March is when the physical is going to come out.
They're doing like four episodes, one for each week in February, and then another one in March, right? The physical copy drops in March.
Yes, and that's what I will be.
They're doing an episode once a week. Mm. I hate that. I mean,
you don't like their Walking Dead-ish.
No, I don't. I mean, that's just a stupid gimmick. That's like the new trend for downloadable games. It's like, oh, let's release it in episodes and make a season at the end of the day.
It says right here. Okay, this is what it says. Four episodes. The first one comes out the 17th of February. The second one comes out February 24th. The third one comes out March 3rd. And then the last one comes out March 10th. And then I think the physical drops probably after that on PS4, which I'll be getting it on PS4. I don't think I'll be spending money on it.
60 frames on PS4?
Sure. It'd be nice, because like that's the thing a lot of people, you know, always said. I remember you mentioned that to me as well, and it's not the fact that like every game has to be in 60 frames, but I'm just saying,
no, it's just a nice little bonus.
It's a nice bonus.
Like, I don't care about resolution at the end of the day, but 60 frames is
it's
nicer
a nice
than
look at Call of Duty. Look at that. Look how smooth that fucking game runs.
Yeah. Call of Duty has always been 60 frames.
So it's like... And then running on, like, the system that is the PS4, I mean, that thing flows. Because you can't just have one without the other. You need everything running at full as you can. And I mean, that thing just is gorgeous looking.
I was surprised when you told me that Revelations is going to be, or not Revelations, Remastered is going to be 30 frames.
Yeah.
Because it's like, they could do 60 frames.
Well,
but they, that's weird that they didn't.
That's the thing. I feel like, I guess, because I know it's going to be on Steam, and I'm buying it on Steam, by the way. I will spend $40 the first day it comes out for the PS4 version and the PC. I'm definitely going to support it all the way by a long shot, because they deserve it, and I love Remake. Because I could just pirate hopefully, it, but I'm really trying to just support them, you know what I mean? Like,
hopefully they'll release it in a case, because...
Hey, you know, I hope so.
Dude. Tomb Raider and the, you know, the new one that just came out, the Legend of Osiris or whatever it's called? That irrelevant game, no one cares.
I like how you just put the stamp, irrelevant game, no one cares. It's just there.
But the reason I bring it up is because it got a case. It's, you know, we sell them at work.
Yeah, I heard
you
about
can,
that.
You can buy it as a case. It doesn't come with a disc. It's just a
token inside, right?
It's a token, yeah. But it's like if they released it with, like, in a case with artwork,
they should do that would be pretty cool. What the fuck?
Yeah, I mean, why not? I mean, if they could do with the
You can afford plastic fucking, cases, Capcom, come on.
If they can do it with that irrelevant piece of shit, then they can do it with this.
Well, I hope so, as well as a physical release on the Remake, because I'd get that on PS4 in a heartbeat, because I think it's like 20 gigs or something. They release the memory and everything, because you can pre-order it now.
20 gigs.
So I think I'm wrong. It might be like 12 or gigs. I don't know. I remember looking...
Okay, Ground Zeroes is like 5 gigs or something like that, and it's... I feel like Ground Zeroes is more technically technologically demanding than Remake.
Well, yeah, because the Fox engine just... I played Ground Zero. It came out for PC, finally. And, oh my god. Like, that game is... Well, when Phantom Pain comes out, I don't know.
Phantom Pain comes out, I'm going to buy it.
I want to have...
And I'm going to play it.
I just want to have Kojima's babies at this point.
No.
Yeah, I mean, that game's going to look fucking amazing.
The fuck? Kojima's babies?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Fucking have Jill's babies. Why Kojima?
I worship him.
Oh. Do you like his face?
I love it.
Are you looking forward
Why
to Silent Hills?
Why can't I have
Hills?
Both, man? The fuck? I like both
Hideo
series.
Hideo Kojima and Jill Valentine. That's threesome.
Great. But no, all jokes aside, what were we talking about? Revelations 2, anyway. Yeah. Will you be buying this in the episode-ish thing that they're doing?
No.
Now... this is the thing that I want to do. It's like I really just want to play it.
Yeah.
But like, you know, as it is released, but like I just don't want to like double dip. Like I don't want to get the digital, and I don't give a fuck about digital. Like obviously with like Remake, they don't give anybody a choice unless, you know, you get the import. But with this, it's like I don't have to double dip. I can just get it one and for all and just put the disc in and that's it.
Yeah.
And then plus, I think you get, like, Hunk or something if you get the physical. I don't know, some shit in raid mode.
If you get the physical, you get bonus stuff.
But it's like...
I think Hunk will be a character in raid mode.
Yeah, they announced the raid co-op.
They said that.
It's the same thing as Revelations. Single player, then you get co-op and raid.
Well, the reason I don't like the whole episodic thing is because it's just a waste of time. You could... just release the physical copy and be done with it.
Well, you know, it's funny you bring that up, because here's the thing. With Walking Dead, it worked. Because Walking Dead wasn't a thing for games. It was its own thing. Resident Evil has never done this before. Why do it now? You know, Walking Dead was establishing itself, and they did an amazing job, because it made, you know, that was Game of the Year 2012 for many people. And,
yeah.
You know, I still have not played them fully. But... it's just like, I understand why they did it, because they were just an indie company, kind of like, okay, we're going to do this Walking Dead game. We don't know how this is going to really, like, do, and it did amazing. And that's their thing. That was kind of like the first game, from my knowledge, to really do that and be very successful.
Well, here's the thing. The Walking Dead is a point-and-click game.
Exactly.
Where you have a lot of choices.
And character dialogue and shit, like Mass Effect.
Yeah, like, you can... Your outcome in one episode will continue on to the next outcome.
And next season, as well.
That's kind of why, you know, it works for Walking Dead, is because you have all this choice.
And then Resident Evil, on the
and
other
then
hand.
Resident Evil, it's just... All you're doing in Resident Evil is taking the main campaign, and you're splitting it up into chunks. It's like if they released Halo 5, and they gave you one mission a month, or something stupid like that, or if they gave you, like, two missions a week. It doesn't make any sense.
You would lose fans in, like, a second. They'll be like, what the fuck is this?
Or it's like if they release the next Last of Us or Call of Duty or something.
You get an hour of gameplay, like, every week.
No, they'd be like, oh, you get two to three hours of gameplay a week. It's like, why? What is the point of this?
Well, that's what I'm saying, is that it just doesn't work for Resident Evil. I mean, I get it's like Revelations, like it's like the storytelling elements where it's from different perspectives.
It's like a TV series
in
Revelations 1.
Previously on Resident Evil, like they did that on Walking Dead game. It's like previously on The Walking Dead, blah, 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 blah. But
it was a nice little gimmick, but I don't think... You know, that should influence your decision to distribute the
Revelations
game.
Revelations 1 was not like this. 2...
No, they gave you the game at
they
once.
They gave you the game, and then, yeah, we had to wait for the console version, but they're not just like, well, you know what, now we're going to splice up that version and release it and then give you a physical. It's like, no, we just wanted a fucking physical, and that's what this should be. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm caught in the middle because I'm not going to buy it, but I can download it on PC. Thanks to pirates, because Pirate Bay is also going back
here's the thing.
Online, by the way.
Oh, cool. I didn't know
if
that.
If you go on their website, there's like a timer. It's counting down, so a lot of people are saying that that's what it... You see like their flag in the background. It's kind of cool. But anyway, go ahead.
I'm just going to wait for the physical, because that way I will play it fresh for the first time and add it to the... You know, the Resident Evil shelf.
Yeah, like, I'll pick it up, too. I just don't know, like, I just feel like
Revelations 2 isn't a game that I'm excited for. And not nearly as excited enough to play it as soon as it comes out digitally.
I mean,
I can wait on Revelations 2. That game does not look that enticing to me.
Well, I mean, I just feel like I just really want to know, like, what made them think, okay, this is good to just split up like this. I don't understand. Like, I get
you know,
it's a gimmicky
it's
thing, but, like...
Another thing I don't like about it is that it just screams budget title. It looks like a budget title. It looks like it plays like a budget title. If you compare Resident Evil 5, which came out 5 years ago... If you compare that game to Revelations 2, there's no contest. RE5 wins in terms of...
You're saying it just looks very cheap.
Exactly. I'm not excited for Revelations 2 because I think it looks cheap from what I've seen. I believe that I talked about it in a previous... When we made fun of the comments and we were like people were just making fun of the teaser trailer, which showed no gameplay at all.
Mm-hmm.
And we were like, okay, these people are idiots. They need to wait and see until we get gameplay. Well, we finally did get gameplay, and it's not like I'm siding with the idiots, but I'm just saying, you know, from what I've seen from the gameplay, rather than just judging a one-minute teaser, which had nothing to do with gameplay, the actual game looks cheap. It looks like a budget title. It looks like they didn't have enough money to kind of... do it just physically. That might be why they're doing it digitally, so they get a bit more cash. I don't know.
Well, the thing that And you know, like I said, I agree with what you're saying. Is like it looks okay, in my opinion. I'm just excited to play another Resident Evil game, and it says right here it's coming out March 31st, so literally a month after it starts, and a couple weeks after it ends, we're gonna finally get it. Pretty much in April at that point.
Was Revelations 1 on consoles or last Resident Evil?
Wait, what? Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Holy shit, it's been a while.
It's been a really long time, so...
Okay, I forgot to mention this as well. Another reason why I'm so disappointed in this is because you got a PS4, I got a PS4. Many people went out and bought a PS4, they bought an Xbox One. This is next gen. We bought brand new consoles. So much promise with these things. You know, games are going to look far better than they ever did before on consoles.
And some do.
Games are going to, you know, have gameplay mechanics that we've never seen before. When Resident Evil 5 came out, people were so excited because, you know, Resident Evil 4 was so amazing.
Big shoes and to then, fill.
And then 5 had big shoes to fill, in my opinion. They filled it.
Yep.
They filled them, but, you know, Resident Evil 5... That felt like a next-gen Resident Evil game.
Oh, yeah.
Same vein as Resident Evil 4 did.
It was RE4, right? On steroids.
And some people would say, Resident Evil 5, that's not a Resident Evil game. No, it's not scary. It's not. I don't care.
That game still looks good to this day. It still holds up. It does hold up.
But the thing is that we got Resident Evil 5 5 years ago on at the time, the next-gen systems. What are we getting for the first Resident Evil game on PS4? We're getting a budget title. A game that looks cheap. It plays cheap, too. You've seen the running.
I made a video about it.
Yeah, so it's like, I guess I'm just really disappointed because...
Oh, no, as dude, the first, I understand.
As the first Resident Evil game to hit next-gen consoles, this is very underwhelming, and it's not what I was... You know, hoping
especially
for.
Especially because it's not exclusive to next. It's like for everything. So it's like it's not really trying to be anything more than what it is. It's just like, okay.
It's just, you know, it is what it is. It's
very minor differences between 360, One, PS3, PS4, PC.
It won't feel like a PS4 game. And I bought a PS4 to play new games. I want to move forward.
Yeah, and
I don't want to stay with. And it's okay to play budget games. There's a game that I want to buy called Earth Defense Force. You know what you do in that game? You go around the city, and you shoot giant bugs. And that's all you do in the game. You get rocket launchers, and you can, you know, have a friend play split screen with you. Yeah. And you just go around the city shooting giant bugs, and the graphics are pretty bleh, and the gameplay's pretty basic, but it looks like a lot of fun. For the first Resident Evil, I was hoping for more. But now that it is a budget game, I'm going to have to judge it as such. When it does come out, it could be really good. It could be one of the best Resident Evils of all time. It just won't look as good as some other Resident Evil games. It won't play as well as some other Resident Evil games. It could be really good, though. From what I've seen, though, I'm very unimpressed. Well, I remember when it was first not announced, but they started giving us information about the game, how there would be new enemies called the Afflicted, and how, like, Claire and Moira would have to, you know, Moira would have a flashlight and Claire be, you know, having weapons and such. And it would take place on a prison, and the prison would be on an island, like Code Veronica. And it's like, oh, this sounds really cool. I mean, this sounds like it could be the next-gen Resident Evil for PS4 that we've been waiting for. I mean, I think the last high-budget Resident Evil was 6. So it's been a while.
It has. It's been almost 3 years.
You know, maybe 7's in development. Maybe 7 will be the one.
If 7 comes out, that motherfucking thing better not touch 360 or PS3, because when they do that shit,
it limits
their production. And you've seen it with games.
Okay, here's the thing. I kind of agree with that, and I kind of don't. I agree with it because if they focused on PS4 and Xbox One only, they could max out those consoles to the fullest potential.
Yeah.
They don't have to worry about, you know, downgrading it in order for it to play on Xbox. But at the other end of the spectrum, I can be like, well, maybe they can release a port after they release the next-gen version. But the port can be, like, you know, a discount version or something. Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, I saw a comparison video, and, you know, the guy was running the 360 version beside the PS4 version.
That shit looks like...
And there was so much detail in the PS4 version that was cut out or entirely different on the 360 mm-hmm. version. Like, the apartment building looks completely different, the drop pod at the beginning of the game.
When you're looking over the city and shit, I mean...
Yeah, he's like, you know, like, changing course and all that, like... That's different on 360. It looks different. It still looks good.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have the capability to look like a PS4 version.
Well, what about Evil Within?
Evil Within.
Do you think that there's I've heard there's no real big difference on how it looks.
I've seen a comparison video, and there seems to be a difference in textures.
But
Sebastian's face, for example, like. His beard isn't as detailed on 360 version, and, you know, stuff like that. Like, the ground isn't as detailed as it is
on PS4. And, you know, same thing with, like, Metal Gear Ground Zeroes, where it's like, that was for the other consoles, but, I mean, it fucking... They did not hold back.
Ground Zeroes looks good on the other consoles.
Dude, that looks...
It's just 30 frames.
Yeah, that looks...
Which, if I got Ground Zeroes on 360, I wouldn't care. Because it looks like the same game, but yeah, but it doesn't look like it has as much detail as the PS4 version. But when a game like Call of Duty Advanced Warfare comes out where they actually change the way the level looks, that's when it might be time to stop focusing on, or stop, you know, wasting time on 360 and PS3. But actually, I think they got High Moon Studios to do the current, or the last gen ports. So a workaround for Capcom is they can hire another developer to focus on the 360 and PS3 version.
Well, that's what I hope they do. I know a lot of companies take the easy way out, but hey, look, if 7, which, you know, they always do kind of develop them in the background, you know, of the kind of the spin-offs that we get or what and whatnot, you know, 6, you know, was kind of covered with Operation Raccoon City, Revelations, you know, and stuff like that. So, you know, and so, like, you know, with Revelations 2, you know, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't, because I can play it as they come out. I just won't pay for them. I refuse to. And then eventually get it, and then just play it again, because I probably will play it a couple times, maybe, or it might be like Revelations, or I'll beat it, like, once and just be like, meh.
It looks like it has a lot of the same mechanics from Revelations 1.
Just with RE6 running.
It looks worse than RE6 running.
Yeah.
I mean, RE6 running was different, but it didn't look this bad.
Yeah, that looked pretty bad. I mean...
But it just... I don't know, I feel like this will be just done with once I beat it. You know, like, I'm never gonna... touch it again, unless we play raid mode on PS4, but raid mode in the first game wasn't that good.
Exactly.
I mean, I put time into it, but that was because Jenny liked playing it.
Well,
every time she was like, oh, you want to play Revelations? I'd be like, okay. Like, I got nothing else to play.
Yeah, I really missed Mercs. I missed
Mercs. Mercs is fun.
Yeah.
It was addicting.
Like, when I streamed it the one night, I mean, that was really fun for me, and I was playing by myself, and that's why...
Why don't you ever upload your streams to YouTube? Like, why don't you...
Because I have
why don't you...
Like, do the setting to, like, record it, and for some reason, the last streams that I did just didn't save. I don't know
Weird.
Why. I heard Twitch was having problems with that. I looked into it. But now that I have the Elgato, from what I've seen in the software, because I still have to fucking get it to work for PS3, it looks like...
It's your first day.
What?
It's your first day.
I know. But I'm just saying, I just want it to fucking work, because that's the one thing I was looking forward to. I mean, it works. Like I said, I tried it on 360 and stuff. It looked great. But, what it looks like from the software is that I can stream and record the footage from the software, from what it looks like to me. If that's possible, I don't have to rely on Twitch anymore. Like, Twitch streams it, but, like, if I pull up the, like, you know, Elgato program, and, like, it obviously
It'll
shows...
It'll record it for you.
Yeah, like, it can record it for me, I can save it,
yeah.
And there's no, like, oh, I can't upload that because Twitch decided to just take, to say fuck you and just, you know, stop the streams, because I love to upload.
Well, like, you'd get more traffic if you uploaded it to YouTube.
I know,
like, streaming is cool because it's in the moment and everyone can watch you play live, but there are streams that you've done that I haven't seen.
Yeah, you know, so, like, that's what I'm saying, is, like, I definitely want to
see. Like, now you can upload it to YouTube if the Elgato lets you.
Yeah, so, like, that's why I'm really excited to, like, you know, stream a lot of shit in general, because that's why I want to get this fucking PS3 working, too, is, like, not just for Remake, but, like, you know, I could do, like, anything on that fucking console, because I have all PS1 ROMs I can load on. I got, you know, it's the hacked PS3, so I could boot up games. It just works. Like, that's what I'm excited to do. But like...
Back to Mercenaries, though?
Mercs, though? Yeah. That shit's fun.
That's like, you know, five years later, almost 6 years later, I'm still playing Mercenaries. It is some of the most fun I've ever had in a video game. RE5 and RE6.
Because we could fucking still play that.
Yeah.
That'd be fucking great. I know JJ got those Steam deals on Resident Evil.
Yeah.
He wants to play RE5 co-op. I have not played RE5 co-op in like 2 years.
I'm not into PC gaming. Like, I just don't have any interest in it. Maybe in the future if I get rich.
Yeah, if you have the money for one. Yeah, because they are expensive. But
do you think you're gonna be playing raid mode 6 years from now?
Yeah,
it's probably not.
It's not gonna happen. I think, like, well, all right. Well, we'll bring this up because these are the two things that were shown post last show. We saw the gameplay.
Sucks.
Sucks. We saw the gameplay, but we also got a person returning, which we kind of saw coming. I kind of saw it coming, because I'm just like, how are you going to have his daughter and not the dad?
Yeah,
Barry,
like, it was
Burton's coming back.
Pretty obvious. Yep.
Big Barry, and so we got him now.
Oh, Barry.
Barry, and what do you think of this? Do you think this is kind of cool, or do you think it's just like, meh, like, I still got to play the game, or do you think, like, your first impressions just make anything else announced just bland or cast aside, so to speak?
Don't really have an opinion on it, because I just don't care about Revelations 2. I mean, if this was, like, you know, if I was excited for this game, I'd be like, awesome, Barry's back, you know? But at this point, I'm just like, the game looks average, you know, it's probably gonna be average.
I think it's pretty cool.
I just don't care. I don't know why. Like, it's cool seeing him back, but I wanted him back in a, you know, in a better looking game.
I mean,
not better looking as in, like, oh, graphics are everything, because, you know, I still play games from the PS1 era, but I'm just saying, like, better looking as in, like, I would want him back in a game that looks more exciting to play.
Well, that's the thing where it kind of is, like, at a crossroad for me, because
it's like when they brought back Hunk in Revelations 1. It's like, I don't want to play as Hunk in Revelations. Like, I want him to have a better role in a game. That's just an example.
Well, it's more so of, like, all right, we have these characters that we want to bring back, like Claire, and it's new characters and new enemies and new... It's just...
I'm all for bringing old characters back, as long as they can make it work.
Yeah, I think that's,
like,
always been...
You know, like, I'd like to see Rebecca back. It's been, like, what, 15 years?
Yeah, I mean, it's been a while.
In the story of Resident Evil, since we've seen her.
And that's...
You know, she's probably, like, you know, in her late 20s, early 30s now. More experienced. It'd be cool seeing Rebecca again. It'd be cool seeing Billy again. But... you know, you have to make the game kind of look better, I guess.
I mean, I just feel like, you know, when... Well, you know, in the midst of the Barry discussion with the intro, I know, like I said, I know you're not excited in general, but the intro was released pretty recent. It was like, what, a week and a half ago or something like that. I was kind of late to watch. I watched it like a couple days after because I was just too busy. I had to actually watch it. I'm not going to ask you what you think because I already know, but because people just heard your pretty much opinion of it. I thought... I mean, if you want to say something, feel free.
They heard my opinion on what I think of it as a game.
Well,
if we're talking about the intro, they...
Well, I mean, the way you made it sound with, like, Barry, and so you're just like, well, I'm just not, you know, I'm just not interested, so, I mean, it's like...
That was just the game, but if you want to know if I thought the intro was good, no. I thought it was pretty mediocre. I've covered the graphics, you know, they don't look impressive at all. But the thing I didn't like about the intro was the writing. There's some pretty bad dialogue in the intro, and I hate stupid Japanese mannerisms that, I know it's a game made in Japan, but not every Resident Evil does this, when, you know, Claire was like, oh, hi, and then Moira's like jumping up and down like a little girl. It's like, you're 18 years old. No one says hi that way.
Yeah.
It's like... You know, and I don't think moments like that happen in 4 or 5 or 6.
Well, the thing, and I see what you're saying, and it's not like I disagree, because I don't want to make it sound like, you know, I'm disagreeing with what you're saying.
Listen, there's a scene in the game where Moira says, what the cock? How could that be good? How can someone write a script and be like, what the cock?
I didn't even know she said that.
How can that be good?
You gotta send me that. I gotta watch that.
It's in one of the gameplay videos. She's like, she's walking with Claire. She's like, what the cock is that? And then, and you know, I hate it when they force characters in that weren't always there to begin with.
Well,
kind of like with Simmons, you know, how like they, in Resident Evil 6, it was like, okay, Simmons was one of the people who decided to nuke Raccoon City. But if you play Resident Evil 3, Simmons is nowhere to be found.
Don't remind
me. But in this game, Moira's like, oh, come on, Claire, you've known me for how long? It's like, we haven't known you at all. You haven't been in any other game.
That's why I hope that there's, like, some, like, cutscenes or something. Or, I don't know, who am I kidding? They're not going to do that. Well, here's the thing. The intro...
Hey, do you think they're going to show Wesker's wife? Dude, they're going to have to show Wesker's wife. It's like 2 months later. Hey, what happened to Wesker's wife? I don't know, dude.
Yeah, it's like the thing with, like, I thought it looked interesting, the intro, because I guess I'm just a sucker for, like, okay, new stories in the Resident Evil. This looks kind of cool, like, to see where it could go. Not that it's, like, the best dialogue I've ever seen, or not that it's the best graphics or the best animation, because they talk like
what
puppets.
What the cock?
It's okay. You know, you can talk like a puppet and still be a good game. I mean, Deep Freeze was great on Sega Saturn. No, I'm kidding. The thing is with this fucking game is, like, think about this. And I know that I think we talked about this outside of the podcast, but I think it's relevant because I think we can kind of kick it around as a Resident Evil thing. So we have Revelations 2 coming out. We have the remake coming out as well beforehand. It's coming out in January. This comes out February, March. Do you think that, because I'll ask you this, do you think like, if there is a 7, which we don't know, obviously, and we probably won't know until, I'd say, tail end of 2015, 2016, if that, okay, because I know Street Fighter V, they have to promote other games, but...
Well, they might... They might announce it in January.
Yeah, you never know. Hey, maybe 2015 might be a Resident Evil again, like 2012. I don't know. But I'll ask you this. Do you think that this will just start becoming a fad where we're just going to start getting these remasters and stuff just because that's maybe all they have left in their system?
In terms of Resident Evil?
In terms of Resident Evil. I know a lot of companies are doing that, but look.
I'm kind of scared that they're going to start releasing cheap games like Revelations 2.
I'm
kind of scared like they don't have the budget to do a game like RE5 or 6 anymore.
Because, you know, in the midst of all this discussion, DMC is going to be released in 1080p 60 frames, I think, in March?
We know it's a thing that they're going to do, that everybody's doing remasters now.
Yeah,
yeah. That, I don't know why. That's the new biggest thing.
Like, it's cool. Because it's cool to them is because they're like, oh, we can, you know. And here's the thing: I haven't played DMC. I have not played that version.
I haven't played it
so
either. I'm sure it'll be cool.
$20 or $15, I'll check it out. Or if somebody has it, I can borrow it or share play it.
Well, I'm not against remakes and remasters. I mean, it's a little bit annoying because you want to see new games.
It's annoying when that's all they have left, and I hope
With Tomb Raider on PS4, I love that. You know,
Last of Us
I thought that was great.
It was great because that was needed.
But, like, I want it to feel like an actual PS4 game. I don't want it to feel like, you know, a last-gen game being played on a PS4.
Next-gen.
But Resident Evil Remastered, you know, I'm biased towards that. I can excuse Remake because that's my favorite game. Okay, that'll look cool.
And again, though, to be fair, Remake was in high demand for an HD port for years. For years.
Well, with Remake, here's another thing I should add. It's pretty annoying when they do it with games that were released, like, you know, a year ago or 2 years ago.
Remake,
with
it's
Last
been
of Us,
years.
With Remake, it's been years. Because
and it was an exclusive as well to a GameCube.
Not many people have played Remake.
Yeah.
So this is a good opportunity for people to finally play it.
And that's an exception.
And, yeah, like, you know, I think they released Kingdom Hearts 2 in HD back a few weeks ago. Kingdom Hearts 2 is one of my favorite games. I have yet to play the HD version, but I'm sure that'd be really cool. But Kingdom Hearts 2 is 9 years old. That's more understandable than DMC, which was released, you know, almost 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Last of Us, I never played Last of Us on PS3, so I enjoyed it on PS4. You know, I can kind of see how people got annoyed by that. But at the same time, it's like, don't buy it. If you don't want it, don't buy it.
Yeah, because it was released at such an awkward time where the console was starting to transition over, and a lot of people didn't get a chance to play it, because a lot of people moved from 360 to PS4, and it was kind of perfect.
So, like, I can see both arguments. Like, oh, it's annoying, but if you are annoyed, don't buy it. Or if you haven't played this game, it's a good opportunity to get it. Like, I never played GTA 5. To this day, I still haven't played it. I don't feel like going out and spending $70 on it. It'd be cool to play it on PS4, but I just don't feel like it's necessary to buy right now, you know? Mm-hmm. I guess it just depends on the game, and it depends on your personal taste. Because you can say, oh, this remake looks really cool, but then you can go to another remake, like, Metro. No one cares about Metro.
Jenny does.
Well, I'm sure some people care about Metro. I don't care about Metro.
Jenny does. No, I'm kidding.
Like, I would look at Metro Redux and I'd be like, who cares about this? But then I would look at another remake like Last of Us and be like, hey, that was pretty fun. Or Tomb Raider. So it just depends.
Well, yeah, because it's like, you know, they're not going to force you to buy it. It's for an audience like that didn't play it. Tomb Raider and Last of Us are perfect examples, but
whether this becomes a trend with Resident Evil, I don't know. I mean, if they do remake and it's successful, it would be cool if they did Zero and they added in co-op play over PSN and Xbox Live.
That would be cool.
One person plays as Rebecca and the other person plays as Billy, and the two of us can, like, explore the mansion together and do puzzles together. That'd be really cool. And hey, Capcom, like, you'd be adding in a multiplayer feature that would work. That wasn't even in the original game. I don't even know why Zero's not two-player on GameCube. I don't know why you can't just plug in a second controller and play as Billy or Rebecca.
I guess just because you have to leave rooms a lot of the time, which is why I think, like, if they made it online, that'd make sense.
Yeah, like, online, okay, you know, you could split up, search different rooms at the same time. On one console, though, it's like it would be a little more, you know, annoying, because one guy would be like, I want to go in here, And the other person would be like, no, I want to go here.
And it's all in real time, too. Like, you have to, you know.
But it's like, Zero's not a game where you should be doing that. Shut up and work together, or you're not going to survive.
Well, yeah, and, like, the thing is, and I know a lot of people want to see RE2 remade. I don't think they're ever going to do it at this rate.
That's the kind of game where I'd want them to do, like, a full-on remake.
I
want them to,
but it's just, like, I don't think...
Not like a remastered... Like, Halo 2 Anniversary, that's an exception as well, because it was redone. It was like Resident Evil Remake. Like, they just took it and redid everything.
Well, the thing is with, you know, with Resident Evil 2 is that...
Like, they can't just slap an HD res over a PS1 game.
Well, the thing is, I used to, you know, say I wouldn't rule it out, but it's like the way...
They could do it on the GameCube port, actually.
Yeah, well, yeah, and like the way it's looking, though, with Capcom in general, that's why I just don't think they would even have the time or money to do it. That's why fans fund projects and do things themselves. But, I mean, and I support that. That's cool. I mean, the thing is with them is just like you said, you just feel like shit's going to get cheap. I'm afraid of that, too. But it's just like, because it's like what, you know, I don't like thinking about what ifs, because that's when you just assume shit and look like an ass. But, I mean, what if there's just, like, no, like, future up until this point where it's just kind of in, like, all right, we do this. We do Revelations 2. It looks kind of cheap. But then they're also releasing Remake to kind of just see how it sells, see where the place in the universe. That's why I want to support it. But, like, what if they just, like, don't, like, know? Like, they're just like, well... Like, what if we're thinking 7 is, like, being made like every other Resident Evil is being made in between games, and then it's, like, they're at a point where it's, like, we get these cheaper-looking games, not just Resident Evil, but Capcom games, and then we get these remasters, which gets them side money, but how far is that going to take them? Because they got a million series up their sleeves that they have to worry about.
I only see Street Fighter.
Well, I mean, their names on.
I mean, Dead Rising 3 failed.
Yeah, and
like it sold copies, but the thing about Dead Rising 3 is that if it had sold more, they probably would have added it to PS4.
Oh yeah, they would have.
But they didn't do it.
I know it's for.
That's
PC.
Very unfortunate.
I have not played it yet. I should.
I'd love to play Dead Rising 3. I'd love to play it. I love the first two, but
that's what I'm saying. I should play it on PC because I like the first two. Like, why not? You know what I mean? It's just kind of one of those things where it's like, why would I just ignore it? I played the first two and then just suddenly stopped.
But this is another Capcom game where it didn't get anywhere. Street Fighter V, that's going to be...
Dead Rising 3? Or did you, like, compare it to the other? Because, I mean, that was when Capcom started this whole route of, like, okay, we don't have
money.
Well,
from what I've seen in gameplay videos, it looked good. It didn't blow me away visually. And the frame rate got pretty choppy. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's a problem on the fucking consoles even running on, so that didn't help.
Dead Rising 1 doesn't have frame rate problems.
Dead Rising 1 was fucking amazing looking as well.
It was very smooth.
That came out in August of 06. I remember buying that, coming home, and I was just like, these graphics are because, like, RE5 wasn't out, and I was just like, how is RE5 gonna look? Like, holy...
Well, here's the thing about Dead Rising 3 that I wasn't really into. It takes place in a city now. Mm-hmm. It's huge. Make it set in a mall. And that way, the environment is smaller, you can have better graphics, and you can have better frame rate. But if you like, you know, I think developers kind of get the sense where it's like, we have more memory and more power on these new consoles.
Our
worlds
too,
can be...
Because Microsoft was like, all right, we're going to give you this money. You got to release it by this time. And it just felt rare. The systems didn't only feel rushed, but the games that came along with it, such as that, did kind of feel rushed. And I didn't even have to play it to kind of get that vibe from it.
Well, Dead Rising 3 is not the only game that does this. It's like...
There's several.
They feel the need to expand the way the world is. Like, we got to make the world as big as it can be. It's like, no.
It's
no.
Like, if you can't do it, you can't do it. Don't make yourself look like an asshole.
It's like, make a mall. Make a mall the size of Dead Rising 1 or Dead Rising 2, because the next-gen console could handle that no problem. And then, you know, have a lot of zombies and make it smooth. Just make it smooth and make it look good. And there you go. I don't know why you have to set it in a city where you get choppy frame rate. Well, and
you know, that's the thing where, you know, now it's like they have established themselves, the consoles, they both companies. Nobody cares about Wii U now. And so it's just like...
Well, Wii U has been getting some better games recently.
I know it. I'm just fucking around. But as far as like these games we're Wii talking U. about, we're not the Wii U. They're not going to be on Wii U. Wii U. Fucking Revelations 2 isn't on Wii U, okay? So at this...
It's not even on 3DS.
It's not even on 3DS. So at this point...
When they first announced that it wasn't on 3DS, I was like, yes, they're not wasting their time with a handheld. This is good. But then I saw the gameplay, I'm like, okay, this cheap game could definitely go on 3DS.
It was excusable because the framework was already there from the DS version, the 3DS version.
They meant for Revelations 1 to be a DS game.
Yeah.
From the get-go.
But this, it's like a home
console. This one, it feels like it could be on 3DS. It feels like it was on 3DS, but it wasn't.
Game.
Or a home console. It doesn't feel like a home console. It feels like a cheap budget game like Revelations 1.
Well, that's what I'm saying is that like, do you think that like, as far as you know, because I'm not saying I don't have faith in the series. I'm not going to make it sound like I don't. I'm just saying, does it make you wonder that, you know, with this happening, it's just like, is Capcom either going to one just keep doing these, like, you know, remasters, or are they going to see the sales on both of these upcoming releases of Resident Evil and Revelations 2? Or is it just, like, that...
If you want my honest opinion on sales, I don't think many people are going to buy Revelations 2. I don't think many people are going to go out of their way to buy it digitally, and I don't think many people are going to go out of their way to buy it physically.
But what about Remake? Well, I mean, what do you think?
I don't want to say that it won't sell, but my honest opinion is that Remake won't sell very much.
Do you feel like it's just too late to the party?
I think it's too late to the party. Nobody cares about classic survival horror anymore.
It's Leon too late to his recruiting party in the second game.
Yeah. Sorry, but looks like your party has been canceled.
Like, it shows up, and it's like, hey, guys, I'm here, right? Yeah, you wanted me? And then it's like, yeah, you know, it's like, you have the people that kind of, you know, like me and you, who are going to eat it up, and I've obviously already owned Biohazard, and I think it's great. Like, that's the thing.
I love classic survival horror, but I don't think a lot of people do. So, I mean, if you made a Resident Evil game in the same vein as Dead Space 1... That would sell more.
Well, because now you got games like Evil Within, which did fairly well. It kind of shows that like, fan base...
That did fairly well.
You know, it's still there. It's just whether or not people, like...
I think Evil Within was the second best-selling game in the UK or something when it came out.
Same thing with Alien Isolation. Great game. Survival horror.
Oh, yeah.
Really well compared to Colonial Marines that nobody wants to talk about. And justifiably so, because you have this...
Well, Colonial Marines sold a lot.
It did, because people were
fooled. That was on the top of the sales charts, because Alien's very popular in the UK. I don't know why, but...
And hey,
might be at UK developers, but I think the Alien games are just popular over there.
My coworker, he was like, dude, I went to the midnight launch for Colonial Marines.
Oh my god.
And dude, he said,
oh my god.
He said that there was a line so far down. Like, people were ready for a good game. It's so hard.
Can you imagine their disappointment?
That's what I'm saying. I was just like, dude, he literally says, like, dude, I went in there the next day and just fucking traded it in. He said there was a line of people that were trading it in. Like... And so you get Isolation, which is, like,
that's
people were iffy about, and I don't blame but it was good, so it's just like, okay, well, people thought survival horror was dead, but then you got these two really good games that are just, they're fucking fun. I loved Alien, I loved Evil Within, I did an LP on it, I mean, there's nothing that I see wrong with survival horror nowadays coming out of the woodwork with these games, you know, whether it's something like Alien, which is based on something, or Evil Within, which is a new IP overall. So it's just like whether people
are... I think it goes back to our earlier discussion on the TV shows. Capcom needs to give the game the budget it deserves. They need to take it seriously with a lot of passion, and they need to make the game look, play, and sound good. Resident Evil 6 was very misguided, but it had the budget.
Yeah, you can tell. It looks great.
You could tell it was a high production game. Like, a lot of people worked on that game. It looks amazing. Revelations 2 looks like shit. So, with RE7, like, I mean... I don't mind it if they make an action game. It's a survival horror, or originally it was a survival horror series, you know, and I would prefer a survival horror game like Dead Space or a Remake or something that's trying to be survival horror, not an action game with lackluster horror. You know what I mean?
I see what you're
saying. In Leon's campaign, for example, it's like it starts out very, like, you know, lackluster, and then it goes into a plane crash in China. In Revelations 1, it's like, okay, this ship is awesome, the atmosphere is spooky, this is creepy, and now I'm in a building shooting millions of hunters with an assault rifle. I feel like, you know, Capcom needs to focus on one... If they do an action game like Resident Evil 5, excellent.
Yeah,
I don't care.
That's what I'm saying.
Just make
it
good.
What the fuck, man?
Make it good. I don't care. If you made a game like Resident Evil 5 again, I would eat it up, and I would put 100 hours into it. I put 100 hours into, or 107 hours into RE6. Something crazy like that.
Because
the Mercenaries was so much fun. You had the co-op campaign. Whatever. The story was a little... It was misguided, you know?
I found myself having some fun, especially Jake's campaign, just going back and, like, doing it on professional. Like, I thought it was kind of very enjoyable.
Yeah. I remember going on professional, and I remember...
getting the emblem,
I was
too. I was taking
it, like, very seriously, so, like, I wasn't using too much ammo. Like, when I was playing as Chris for the first time on professional, like, I was like, okay, I'm in a squad, and I gotta be very slow and tactical with this, and I was like, I found myself taking a lot more cover and, you know, saving my ammo, and that was cool. That was fun. Most of the time, you go on hard mode and you get pissed off. I played three out of the four campaigns without infinite ammo on professional.
Oh, I didn't play with infinite ammo at all. I did that shit legit.
It wasn't until Ada where I was like, hey, I can buy infinite ammo now.
I just never even bought it until
I didn't.
Like, I didn't even think about it because, like, I was just like, I just have to.
I didn't have enough enough skill points
to
buy it.
I think that was
first.
My thing too. Yeah.
So when I got to Ada's campaign, I finally had enough. So I was like, might as well. But my point that I'm trying to make is, Capcom needs to focus on one genre. One. If you're making an action game, make an action game. If you're making a horror game, make a horror game. Don't try to fucking blend the two. It worked with Resident Evil 4. I think that was a one-time deal, though. I don't know how else
RE5,
to defend that.
Though, I thought RE5 was fucking fantastic.
Yeah. RE5 was like survival action. That was great. You know? It was tense. It was cool. But it was action. But you were still surviving. Resident Evil 6 was action without the survival mechanics. Like, it didn't really feel like you were surviving. It felt like you were going around shooting things. It was still fun, though. But it had lackluster horror in Resident Evil 6. Like, you know...
Do you think that Revelations 2 could have any horror, or do you just don't think that? I mean, obviously...
I see that it's trying to be scarier again, but then in the trailer, Barry whips out an assault rifle, and he mows down, like, you know, 15 zombies. So I don't know how it's going to be, like, in terms of, like, action.
Do you feel like it's going to have, like, a balance, just, like, you know, 6, or not really 6, I should say, like, 5, maybe? I feel like I'm going in this too much expectations, but, I mean, do you think that, like, it would at least be, like, so, because a lot of people saw that and draw conclusions, like, oh, it's just going to be action, this is so typical, but it's just, like,
I saw a comment where the guy looked at Barry with the assault rifle, and he's like, typical Resident Evil. This is...
He fades to black, and he just says...
And in some ways, he's right. You know, like I said, Revelations 1, RE6, they had their moments of, you know, what genre am I? But...
That could be just one episode where it's more action-oriented. I mean, I'm just trying to...
If they have one episode that's more action-oriented and then another episode that isn't, it's fucking stupid. I don't want that. Make an action game, make a horror game. Stop trying to blend the two. Because you lose focus on what you're really trying to do at the end of the day.
Yeah, exactly. I think like when they're trying to execute something that has a story already that started from survival horror, you really have to know what you want. You can't just be like a fucking, you know, just... like a selfish asshole and be like, all right, well, this is making money right now in the gaming industry. Let's do this. Let's do this. It's just like,
yeah,
you're not, that's, you're,
I think that's what they're trying to do though. They're trying to cater to everyone.
Well, I feel,
and it's like pick an audience
with like Remake and stuff. You know, if they base stuff on their sales or if they actually does, hey, if it sells well, and if it gets a physical release here in America, that must say something. And I don't know. Okay.
If it does.
Well, that's what I'm saying. And then, so...
I remember, you know, the first time I played through Evil Within, that was a tense game.
Oh, yeah, that was insane.
Evil Within was... It wasn't terrifying, but there were many moments in Evil Within that were very dreadful, very dark, and it's like, I feel uncomfortable playing this, but it's very fun, so I'm going to keep playing this.
Yeah, it was very hard and just very, like, it just kicked you when, like, you were down. Like when
Spider Bitch comes out,
God.
It's like you have no choice but to run. And it's creepy. And like you said, it kicks you when you're down. It keeps giving you challenges to overcome
with
dread and limited resources. And that's great. Sometimes there's like a little action scene, like when you're trying to rescue Kidman from drowning.
Yeah, I remember that.
But it gives you ammo during those little segments. It's not like it's like, you know, sending hordes of enemies at you and it's giving you nothing to work. It's like, it depends on the situation, but Evil Within is a good example of a modern survival horror game. Dead Space 1 is a good example of a modern survival horror game.
Oh, Dead Space, I miss you so much.
Where the fuck is Dead Space 4?
EA, stop fucking up, man. Stop fucking up.
I don't give a shit about Battlefield Hardline. Give me Dead Space 4.
Like, I don't know. I just... Dead Space is another great thing where I really hope it's not one of those, like, missed opportunities where it's like they could have had a really good thing going to continue, you know?
Dead Space 3 is kind of like Resident Evil 3. It's the final game in a trilogy that people said had more action than the first two.
Yeah, but except 3 was kind of
feel like
fucking good and has a cliffhanger.
I feel like Dead Space, that was kind of the Resident Evil trilogy of our generation.
That's really good, actually, yeah, because, you know, I thought 3 was a great game. The DLC is cliffhanger, but...
It was fun. It was great.
It was fun, good balance. I remember talking about it on one of the first podcasts. Great game. I ate it up. I loved 2, and... I went back and played 1 in the midst of 3 coming out. And, you know, again, that's an example where it's like, I felt like, personally, with Dead Space, the trilogy, Dead Space as a whole, it changed some stuff up. It tried some different things, but I never felt like the focus was really lost on the tragedy at hand with the marker and a lot of stuff that was kind of changing and evolving without giving anything away. So, like what you said, you know, what Capcom does, which they struggle with doing, is that, you know, they just do one or the other, or they try to do both. When, like, Dead Space 3 kind of was the more, a little bit more different route, I thought that they hit the nail on the head as far as balancing co-op or single player or the decisions, and like you see different things
yeah.
and you play as the co-op partner. I thought that was fucking badass. And
well, Dead Space 3 was more like Resident Evil 4.
Yeah.
I think Resident Evil 4 is a one-time deal in terms of Resident Evil. Mm-hmm. But another game that I think blended the two pretty well was Dead Space 3.
Yeah, and Dead Space is influenced by RE4 alone, so...
Dead Space 3 was the weakest out of the three, but it still had a good balance of horror and action.
It felt like the focus was still there. It didn't really feel lost.
Yeah. Like if you play that shit on single player, it gets pretty intense.
Yeah, and I thought it felt very, you know, guided. I thought that it did have direction. It did have kind of like a point A to point B. This is, you know, this is what you have to do, you know, for, like, this is what you're going to
experience. But, you know, like, I don't think Capcom has to sacrifice the co-op campaign either. I think they can find a way to make it work. You know, single player, you're by yourself.
That's what I think we're going to find out in 7, because obviously, I guess, Revelations, they strictly just stick.
I don't think they're doing that, though, because in Revelations 2, you have fucking Moira following you around. It's like they don't learn. If you want to be scared, you have to be by yourself. Co-op is meant for having fun together. You know, it's more of like an action experience, but it's like watching each other's backs.
Well, that's why I hope she's not always there.
I mean, I'm sure, like, sometimes you'll split up, but hey, you split up when you're with Helena, for example.
Like, Evil Within, you were alone a lot, and you were people, but then they'd get separated, and, like, that's what I like.
Yeah, sometimes you team up with Joseph. Most of the time, you're by yourself.
Yeah.
But if they were to do it right, you know, they could be like, okay, so you have your single-player campaign, and you have your co-op campaign, which is still, it's still pretty intense, but you're with someone else. If you're looking for a more action-oriented thing, or I guess co-op's kind of become like Resident Evil's thing lately. So it's like, if you don't want to leave that out, if Capcom absolutely has to have co-op inside, I mean, I don't care, to be honest. Like, I would just say, like, you know, drop it and focus on single player. But if they're going to have co-op, do it the way Dead Space 3 did it.
It's funny how, like, Dead Space wasn't, like, Resident Evil was kind of one of the first, like, horror games to have co-op, and Dead Space ended up doing it better in the long run, and they just did it for, they did it for one game.
I mean, it worked in RE5, though, because that was, like, that fit
well,
the tone really well.
It worked in RE5. Like, that was one, like I said, RE5 was one of the first, like, co-op horror games, and that's, like, after that, it's just, like,
but it's
did
like,
you lose?
Oh, it works because it's, like, action survival, but... Yeah, and it works for Resident Evil 6 because that's an action game, but it's, you know, with the exception of those stupid horror moments, that's not really scary. But, you know, Revelations
just,
1, for example.
It's just an interesting time right now in gaming and in general and how companies are going about things. I don't know what to expect. I have high hopes for the series. Like, I hope Remake does very well. I hope Revelations 2 is enjoyable. I'm trying to be optimistic, but I'm also trying to be realistic. I'm not going to just sugarcoat and be like, I know it's going to... Like, I'm not going to say I know. I'm going to say I hope, because that's all you can really do is just, like, pray that... I hope when I sit down and put the controller in my hand and fucking play these games that it's okay. Like, it's all right.
I don't want to sound like I'm trying to hate on...
I know you're not.
Hate on Revelations 2.
I mean, we've talked about our several times during these shows.
We're not like the idiots on YouTube who are like, you know, this sucks because it sucks. Mm-hmm. Like, I explained why I don't like Revelations 2, and it's justifiable. But I really want them to make the best Resident Evil game that they can. That could be why I'm so disappointed with Revelations 2, because I know they have the potential to do much, much better.
Yeah, we all know that.
And as any fan of any series, I would want them to really deliver. If they're just going to keep giving us cheap games, then why the hell should I care? You know what I mean? It's like with 2012, we had Raccoon City, that was really cheap. We had Revelations on DS, you know, pretty cheap. We got Resident Evil 6 at the end of the year. That was cool.
That was
but
made during that time.
That was, you
that
know.
Probably started production, I'd say, around 2010.
That started production,
yeah.
Like, right after RE5, I think.
Oh, yeah, even, yeah, what am I kidding? Fucking, that was probably, like, they probably already had the concept, like, in 2009. They probably started working on it, like, early 2010, I'd have to say.
You know, a lot of people hate on Call of Duty, but the newest one, Advanced Warfare... That took 3 years to make. Not a lot of people realize that. They're always like, oh, Call of Duty is the same every year, and, you know, they make one for each year. It's like, yeah, but you don't know that sometimes a lot of work goes into them. And Advanced Warfare, that started development right after MW3 came out. It was 3 years in the making.
And it
shows. I beat it today on, you know, Christmas, and it was great. It was awesome. I can't play multiplayer because of the fucking Lizard Squad. I really want to. But Advanced Warfare is a good example of a game that they put a lot of work into, and it shows. There's a big difference between AW and Ghosts. I think Ghosts, that wasn't 3 years. I couldn't have been that 3 years. No. But, you know, that's just an example of another series that they spent a lot of time with the game, they put a lot of work into it, and it shows. Does Revelations 2 really show that they, you know, tried with it? I mean, maybe. But for the money that they got, but, you know. It's like, I know you can do better, Capcom. I've seen it before.
Yeah, so it's like you've already established yourself as, like, this company that can do great things, and we expect great things. Like, we understand if you make mistakes, but learn from them and kind of keep the ball rolling and don't, like, try to backtrack and figure out what you're doing wrong over stuff that doesn't really matter. Like, if you look at what you do wrong, but, like, try to keep moving forward and, like, taking a different approach to it as, like, okay, we have this thing where we're going to lose a lot of people if we don't fucking just make something that has a lot of, like, heart into it.
Do you ever get the sense that they're wasting their time with these side games?
I don't. It's something that Resident Evil has always done, and I understand it now, obviously, looking at it from, like, an older perspective, especially, like, with the Wii games and shit, you know, that were exclusive. It's like
Dead Aim, Outbreak.
Yeah, and, like, yeah, stuff like that, and, you know, like, nowadays, I think so. Back then, no. But I think that because of how The Last have been treated, the last couple stuff that we've seen, it's just like, okay, Capcom, this isn't 2003, 4, 5, 6, even 7, even 8. Like, this is now, you don't have a lot of money to be doing these. You either have to get in or get out. Like, keep doing it. Because, you know, people are like, well, they might reboot it. Well, that was shattered once they said they're going to remake, like, you know, remake, what the hell? We already talked about this. Remaster remake is what I meant to say. Remaster remake for the, you know, current gen consoles and last gen consoles. That's fine. But I feel like now, should we be seeing Revelations 2? No. We should see nothing.
You know what I think they should do? Honest to God, this will risk the entire franchise, but I think they should go with it. Fuck the side games. Get that shit out of here. I mean, it was cool when you were younger to play those side games, like, okay, Operation Raccoon City, you know, this will tide me over until 6.
It's like, times are different. You're losing money.
But it's like you're losing money. I'm getting older as a gamer. I want something good. Fuck the side games. Get that shit out of here. And focus on the one Resident Evil game that will end all Resident Evil games. Focus on the one Resident Evil game that will really impress people. And if that does well, you will get your money, and you will be able to make another one.
Yeah,
treat, like I said before with the TV series, like, treat every game like it's your last one. Go out with a bang. Don't just give me side shit that feels cheap. Give me Resident Evil 7 that's either an excellent action survival game with co-op or a very scary dark survival horror game that makes me feel like I'm alone. Do one of the two, but whatever route you go down, make it amazing.
I think it comes to a point where it's like, we don't need to be seeing Revelations 2. Like, yeah, remake, remastered, fine, but, like, I should be seeing nothing right now on Resident Evil's plate. Like, I should just be knowing in the back of my head that they're doing something.
this is what we should be knowing. We're Capcom and we're currently working on a game. A couple months later, yeah, we're still working on the game. A few months later, yeah, we're still working on the game. A year later. So Capcom, you mentioned last year that you're making a game. What is your progress on that? Oh, we're still making that game. And it'll be like, you know, 2 years later, 3 years later, after a couple years of, you know, saying that they're making a game, at least we know they're working on a game. And then it finally comes out and it's like, wow. Like, the 4 or 5 year wait for this was definitely worth it.
Yeah.
Would you prefer that, or would you prefer side games like that come out once every year?
Because, like I said, nowadays, we're really relied on, you know, for them anyway, they're relying on, like, these side stuff. And, like, yeah, it's all fine and dandy, but it's like, we want the main course. We don't want these, like, little appetizers over and over again. It's just not, it's not going to fulfill, you know, ourselves as far as, like, because we're, you know, gamers and fans of the series, loyal fans. It's just, it's not working anymore. It's not working. I don't want to see these ports become a thing. I don't want to see these, like, there's just these spin-offs.
And there's also, there's a difference between a port and a remake as well.
Yeah.
Like, if, you know, the ports I can understand. If they come out and they say, we're remastering Resident Evil 2 from head to toe, I'd be all for that, because it's a, it would be a high-budget game, and it would be, you know, a classic being brought back. But if they're porting Resident Evil 2 on GameCube, fuck that.
And that's what I'm saying, is that, like, maybe, like, in the future, if they make, like, this one big game that's going to get them a lot of money and they're able to do that, cool. But right now, I think it's just, like...
Resident Evil 4 broke records in terms of sales.
And that's coming from a game that, like, and that literally had... It was scrapped.
Over and over again.
Just like RE2, and had trouble getting released, but it's still...
Even more so than RE2.
Even more so, yeah, because that thing fucking went on...
And RE5? That wasn't as well-received as RE4, but that was even more successful based on how much people loved RE4.
And RE6 was, like, probably, like, I...
Wasn't as successful.
I think it eventually sold a lot more copies than 5, I think.
I think they sold the ones... They didn't sell as much as they hoped for when it came out.
But it eventually...
Over time, more people bought RE6, but it wasn't right away, like RE4 and 5. But if you keep giving us all of these side games, like I said earlier, I don't think many people are going to care enough to go out and buy Revelations 2. I don't think many people are going to care enough to buy Remake Remastered.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, is, like, I think now it's,
but
like it's just time
if,
to go
if
back.
You give us, like, if you make a game that's, like, you know, 3 years in the making, 4 years in the making, and you start, you know, advertising it everywhere, and people know about this, it'll become a giant name. People will know that game, and people will want to play that game.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I just feel like it's just time to go back to the drawing board and just be like, all right, we need to, let's just do this. Like, let's just fucking go and
I feel
use
like
Street Fighter, like, money and fucking make this or something, because Street Fighter sells.
Listen, like, if this, you know, if they were to do that, cancel all side games and make one Resident Evil game that's just amazing, and if that one Resident Evil game didn't sell well, I would rather see the franchise end than keep getting these cheap games. I don't want Resident Evil to be something where people remember it based on the shitty games.
Yeah, that it became at one point, you know, like...
You know, Resident Evil used to be a series full of AAA exclusives. Installments. The trilogy on PS1, 4 on GameCube, 5 on, you know, PS3 and 360, which were at the time next gen. AAA games all the way.
Yep.
Remake on GameCube. 0 on GameCube had the same budget as Remake. It Well, I don't know about that, but it had the same, like, style as Remake.
Same engine.
It just wasn't as... Yeah, it wasn't as good in the story department, but it still had a lot of, you know... That looked like a good game. But I don't want to see, like... I want to see people going... Yeah, you remember that series with the shitty games, like... Operation Raccoon City and Revelations and Outbreak and Dead Aim. Dead Aim's cool, but you like Dead Aim because it's stupid. You don't like Dead Aim because it's amazing.
Yeah, like, it's... I just think that nowadays it's time to just stop cutting around the fucking bullshit and just, like, face
and,
it.
You know, if they wouldn't be forced to sell Resident Evil to someone who could give it the care that it deserves. I want Sony to get Resident Evil, in all honesty.
Great.
I mean, you've seen what they do with Uncharted. You've seen what they do with Heavy Rain and Infamous and Killzone, Last of Us.
I don't know, man. It's
what's the one thing that those games have in common? They all have a budget,
and they all take years to make. Yeah. Years to make.
Shadowfall came out like 2 years after three. Like,
they started Last of Us in 2010. Like.
No, they started in 2009.
I think
it was right after Uncharted 2.
It was literally like they finished one thing and went right into the
They divided the team, right?
Yeah,
so
that's
like
what
one
they
half
did. Yeah, they divided.
One half did Uncharted 3 and then the other half did Last of Us.
Neil Druckmann, who his first game he directed, Uncharted 4 being his second, one that is still coming out technically this year, I should say, because it's pretty much 2015 at this point. And, I mean, that game speaks volumes on so many levels. A lot. Like, I got a comment. I was like, why'd you put that in front of RE4? It's just like, hey, I don't know. It's my opinion. It's just how it impacted me. It's not like one's like better than the other. It's just my personal placement. You know, you can't compare RE4 to Last of Us. You can't compare Last of Us to Spider-Man. It's just what it is. I don't, you know, it's like, I'm not, you know, not saying anything bad about the comment. I'm just saying that, like, you can't expect something from somebody. They're going to just tell it like it is. And that's kind of how I did my list. I was like, hey, look, this is how I kind of feel about this. And, hey, you know, RE4 is amazing. And it doesn't change that because there's games in front of it. You know, it's just like, they're all great games. That's what I said in the comment. I responded. I was like, it's just my personal placement, but like they're all perfect in my opinion. All those games that I listed, and that's why I finally like made the video, because pretty much share it. And like Last of Us, you know, like I said, it did something to put it all the way in front. Because I mean, it's one of the best games I ever played. I mean, hands down. And it's because it's such a big team and big story.
It's very rare to say that about a game that comes out these days.
And that's what I'm saying, is that, like, now's not the time to be doing this side shit. It's not,
you know,
the
I think
time.
Evil Within started development in 2010.
Evil Within, yeah, that's been in...
That game took 4 years to make.
That's been in the...
It's not the most graphically impressive game, but it's a game that has... It had a lot of care put into it.
And it's just not the time to just do this. It's not the right time. You could have done it any other time, but now. This is not a good time for gaming. This is not a good time for the series to just be jerking off on this, you know, spinoff. And that's fine. Like I said, if it's okay, that's all right. But
they could make a system seller if they wanted to.
Yes.
Right now, we don't have many games on... Next gen.
You know how cool it would be if, like, they kind of did, Sony pulled what Microsoft did, and they just went to Capcom, and they're like, yo.
Yeah,
make
like...
Make this game. Make this Resident Evil. Fuck it. We'll give you the money. You make this an exclusive.
We'll give you the money. Make it good. And then they do it, and then it sells more PS4s.
Yeah, it's
because,
like,
it's so good.
That's just what it is. It's like, Sony has money. Microsoft has money. Even if it was vice versa. I mean, I don't have a... Well... Technically, I have an Xbox One in the house, but it's not mine. But it's just like, do whatever you have to. Just make something really good. And like, I know they want to sell it to the masses, but hey, I mean, if you're a company struggling and a big company like Sony or Microsoft says, hey, we'll give you this paycheck. We know you don't have it, but we're going to give you it. We're going to fund you okay? We're going to be the publishers, and you're our devs, and you're going to fucking make this game great. And it's like, and they're both, and they're all on the same page, and then they make it, and then it's actually really good, and it's fucking like a salvation of the whole thing. It's just, it's not the, the ugly, you know, stepchild anymore. It's just like, hey, you can mm-hmm. fuck, you know, you can make this good, and I like to see that. And I'm not, like I said, hey, will I do a review on Revelations 2? Probably. I'd like to.
Oh, yeah.
I'd definitely like to share our experiences and talk about it on a podcast with other people. That would be cool.
One thing I need to point out is that I'm not saying it will be a bad game.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I know that.
I'm just saying it doesn't look like a good game right now.
That's what I'm saying.
But I could play it and I could be like, okay, this is better than I thought it would.
Well, my opinion is the same as yours when it comes to, like, this just isn't going to work if they just keep doing this. And that's what I'm saying. I know that, you know, you're going to be, me and you are both open to the game as far as what our final, you know, justified opinions are going to be. And that's fine. I feel like now is just not the right time to be getting this. Like, it's cool and all, and I like to see these characters come back. I think it looks awesome as far as, like, hey, it's awesome to see Claire back. It's awesome to see Barry back. It's cool.
When I first, you know, I mentioned this earlier on the podcast, but when I first found out about Revelations 2, I was very excited. It became my number one most anticipated game. You know, island, prison, new enemies called the Afflicted, going to be scary. It sounds like it could be a great next-gen game. But then I saw the actual footage, right? And it's like, this could have been so good. Like, the concept is there. You know, but the way the gameplay flows and the way the game looks, Claire looks fucking ugly as all hell. I don't know what happened there. She has a different voice actor. It's like, that's not
everything
Claire.
Everything is gone with the old Resident Evils. The character designs, the character models.
Barry looks like Barry. Barry looks like Barry, and he has the same voice actor from Remake, but I just don't care enough.
Yeah, it's like, they seem to be just slowly shedding off what once was. And I feel like this is going to, I'm not going to say make or break them, but I just feel like they really just need,
I feel like they're wasting their time.
Because even if you, like, stop making Resident Evils for, like, a couple years, I'll be fine as long as you're making something good. Like,
They didn't release anything
since
this year.
Yeah, anything since fucking Revelations. That's it. On home consoles.
And even Revelations in 2013 for home consoles, I don't count that as a new one.
No.
So really, our last main one was Resident Evil 6.
October 2012. And
Like, they could, I mean, they did the same shit with Dead Rising. You know, Microsoft was like, hey, make this for us, and we'll pay you. I feel like, you know, if Capcom can't do it, just give it to someone else who can't. Or they should just sell off everything except for Resident Evil and Street Fighter. I mean, I can't seem to think of any other games that they do. They did Mega Man, which I think they canceled. They did Okami, which was really good, but that didn't get anywhere because it didn't sell many copies. They did. I can't even fucking think of other games like Capcom. Marvel vs. Capcom? What else did they do?
They did,
look this shit up. It's very obvious. There's, like, their names that they've done. They did Devil May Cry. But I think they gave that to Ninja Theory, didn't they? DuckTales.
Hey, that sold really well. Strider?
When was the last time we got a Strider game? Oh, yeah, it was a digital release. They did Monster Hunter, which is mainly popular in Japan.
Oh, yeah.
Monster Hunter!
I remember the I remember the save theme in that game is the same as RE4's.
Oh, yeah, really?
I remember Brennan, my friend Brennan, was playing it on PSP back in the day. And, like, or not, it was the merchant theme when you're, like, you know, in his area. I was just like,
yeah,
that's fucking, that's the merchant theme. And he was like, well, this is by Capcom. And I was like, oh, okay. Like,
yeah,
very interesting that they did that. But, I mean, hey, it's free music they can use again, so I don't blame them.
It's like, hey, wait a minute. Monster Hunter. That sounds like a game that could probably benefit from the PS4's hardware. Mm. Why aren't we getting that? No, instead we're getting handheld games. Lost Planet. Last one was 3. I don't think that did very well. Why do they have these series if they don't, like just get rid of them and focus on Street Fighter and Resident Evil, because those are your biggest ones.
Well, it's only gonna, it's gonna benefit people that, like, I just want to know what their motivation is. Like, where is this going? Like, are you actually going to do something that's very, like, all right, like, we have these series that, it's just like, where are you just heading at this point? Like, that's why I was, like, really trying to ask, like, do you think that they even really have a direction, or they're just kind of like, we're just going to do what we can to get by?
Mm-hmm.
Instead of, like, we are working on this one thing that we're holding you over, and that's fine, but it's like, dude, sometimes you just have to stop making those games and just focus on it. I'm fine with waiting. Look at fucking Metal Gear. You get one spinoff between 4 and 5, but it's just like, sometimes less is more, and you could just...
Well, Ground Zeroes isn't really a spinoff.
No, I'm talking about Rising Revengeance, or whatever it's called. That one.
If you want, you can count Peace Walker, which came out after 4.
True. I mean, I know they all...
I mean, Capcom's making this game called Deep Down. That's an exclusive for PS4. I'm sure that might be good.
I don't know, man.
It was developed by Capcom Online Games and Sony Computer Entertainment Japan. And I don't know. I'm sure Deep Down will look beautiful.
I just hope so.
I haven't seen much from the game, but I mean, they're focusing on Deep Down as a new IP. That's cool, but why can't they give that treatment to Resident Evil?
That's why I guess,
like, just make it look amazing and make it amazing as a game.
Well, that's why I think, like, you know, we have all this, you know, cool stuff that could be done. We just don't know what's going on behind it all. I think, like, we have a lot of potential. We have this game that a lot of people take seriously. Why aren't we pushing it forward? And maybe they are. Like I said, I'll play these games. I'll play these ports. I'm fine. I got other games I'm looking forward to in 2015. You do as well. So it's just... You know, and apparently Deep Down is also a free-to-play title.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it says right here, Capcom producer Yoshinori Ono announced that Deep Down is a free-to-play title.
Oh, no. That basically means that it's gonna suck.
So... Capcom's attempt at a role-playing game.
Why make it free to play? You're not. I mean, do they get money based on how many downloads it gets?
Do they get money on
microtransactions?
Might just get paid in advance. I don't know.
How do they make money off of this?
Well, here.
Why do they bother?
Is the one thing is that, like, think about it. Street Fighter V was exclusive to Sony. Yeah. So it's like,
no.
I mean, I guess they're getting money somewhere. You know, like that obviously was in advance that they're just like, you're making, same thing with Tomb Raider. Like, you're making this for Xbox One only right now. Obviously, I think Street Fighter, you know, 5 will still get eventually released. Same thing with Tomb Raider. But the fact of the matter is that money talks. They got paid a certain amount to just do that. Companies don't just do that just because that's what it can run on. We've seen Street Fighter 4 on every console. It's coming out for fucking Windows as well, Microsoft Windows, Street Fighter 5. But for home consoles, just PS4. And it's being advertised just for PS4. With Sony logos and shit. So it's like, they're getting money somewhere.
I think Deep Down will be one of those games that looks pretty, but it'll be like Destiny where it just feels hollow.
You know, it's just...
I think you're just going to go into dungeons and you're going to kill monsters. And but like Warframe, that other free-to-play game where you just go around and you kill shit. Like, I don't know. I was thinking Deep Down was going to be this, like, new IP RPG, and you're going to go to the store and buy it in a nice case. You're going to get your money's worth. You're going to go home and level up your character and shit, and, you know. I don't usually have much hope for free-to-play games, though.
Well,
I mean, what do we have now? We have DCU Online, Warframe. There was that shooter that Brandon plays. What was it called? I forget the name. Black Sight? Retribution or whatever?
Yeah.
You wanna play some Black Sight, Anthony?
No. I'd have to pass on that.
You wanna play some Deep Down?
I'll play Deep Freeze.
I'll play Deep Throat.
Oh, that's lovely. I mean... The things that, you know, we go on all night about, but I just, you know, like I said, I'm going to try to be positive towards what's going to happen.
Yeah.
It's just,
like, we can only hope
for
the best.
We can only
really hope
for the best, and, like, we want to hear definitely what you guys think about pretty much this whole thing.
At this point, I'm looking forward to Remastered simply because I'm... You know, curious to see what it'll look like on PS4. I don't care for Revelations 2, and I'm more excited for what I haven't heard about. I mean,
you know, it's funny.
Capcom's got to be doing something.
It's funny because, you know, I'm looking at the timeline of release games on Resident Evil Wiki page. 2013 and 14 are just nothing.
Yeah, because nothing came out.
Simply nothing. So it's like, what was going on? And I'm not talking about Revelations 2. What was really
going
on? Yeah,
like it didn't take them 2 years.
What was going on
that.
Within those 2 years? Was nothing going on because of money? Or was something happening and something is still happening that we don't know yet? Because RE6 just came out of the woodwork.
Maybe we'll see it in 2016. Maybe they're taking extra time with this one.
But that's what I'm saying. That's why we don't know. And, like, hey, if they're not going to, like, tell us, hey, that's fine. That's cool.
I mean, it's a cool gesture if they're doing... No, it's not really a gesture. We know they're making the side games to make money while they're working on their bigger projects.
That's all right. It's business. We get it.
But at the same time, it's like, wouldn't you make more money without wasting time on these side projects that no one's going to really buy?
They must split it up into teams just so people can, like, you know...
Yeah, like, they probably have, like, a big team working on 7 or whatever.
Like 6, and then they had the other team make Raccoon and Revelations.
But the money that went into Revelations 2 could have gone towards 7.
What money? No, I'm kidding. but,
what
money? The money they just earned on the street or something. But,
well, it does look like a budget title, so $100.
I mean, look, this can go either way. I really hope that... this is going to be, you know, really a wake-up call for everybody. I think, like, if there's this two-year gap where just nothing is going on, I mean, it's like...
I remember we were...
Like, what the hell? It's like,
I remember like the rumor that they were going to show it off at E3. Mm-hmm. You remember that?
I remember the whole Enhanced Veronica thing, which was pretty much a code name for Revelations 2.
Enhanced Veronica. Yeah.
So
what they need to do, first step in achieving success, is write better titles.
Why Revelations 2? Like, why? This has nothing to do... This isn't a revelation. This has nothing to do with the first... You could just call it Resident Evil Tits, and it would be, like, just the same convincing title. There's just... It's just lazy. Just feels like...
It should be called Resident Evil Escape from Guantanamo Bay.
Yeah, exactly. Resident Evil, watch our characters constantly get older in bad games. No, it's like...
They changed the face for Claire, and they changed the face for Jill. Who's the next face going to
like
be?
Their money's getting lower, so it's like, fuck, we can't put this time in these people's faces anymore. Fuck it.
We can't even afford Julia Voth. What are we doing with our lives?
She acknowledges the remake, remastered all the time, which is cool.
Yeah, because she got paid for it. If they're using her likeness again, she will get paid.
But I know she loves like that game, so it's kind of cool that... about that. We'll never see her again, so I guess this is the last time we get the...
I don't understand why, because she is the face of Jill.
She is. I mean, 5 was an important game. We got 1, 3, and 5. Those are, like, through 1 through 6, those are, like, key points where we see Jill.
And then in Revelations, it was Jill from behind. I mean, no one else can have an ass like that.
That's true.
And no one else can rock that ponytail.
That's true.
But then you turn the camera and it's like, who is this face?
Yeah.
And the voice was different too.
Exactly.
I think that's another thing. Capcom, stop messing with your characters, because then you create inconsistency.
Too late for that.
I mean,
but you know,
it's like Chris is gonna have a different voice actor in the next game, and he's gonna have a different face. And he's going to have a different hairstyle.
And he's going to, like, have muscles again.
No, he'll be skinny, like Remake. And we'll be like, what happened, Chris?
I stopped working out.
I messed
it's
up.
It's in, like, 6. That trailer. Was, like, he still had muscle, but it wasn't as, like, overdone.
It wasn't as big as it was in 5.
It's like, what did he do? Just go on a workout spree? Like, oh, I fucking hate Jill. And just, like... doing some shit. It's like, I hate...
Remember that one trailer? The very first trailer we got for Revelations 1?
I messed up.
I messed up. And you saw Hunk?
Yeah.
And Chris and Jill were, like, pissed off at each other, and they were holding each other at gunpoint?
That never happened!
That never happened, and it looked far more interesting than the final game.
Saying. Like, what the fuck?
What?
And it was only for 3DS.
You wasted money on this trailer. What happened in that game?
I'm gonna go and replay RE4 soon, because I got it for PC and 5. They had a great Steam sale. It's a holiday sale. I think it's still January 2nd. Anybody out there listening, go pick...
Oh, wait. Dude, I know what they're going to do next. I know what Capcom's going to do. They're going to re-release the Resident Evil 5 and 6 HD pack.
Now, hang on.
And they're going to bring it to PS4.
I like it because of Mercs. Okay. I'd probably buy it, but I will be buying it while sticking a middle finger in their face, because I'll be like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, I love you, but I hate you. Like,
I'll buy it to support you and for the collection, but what are you doing?
It's like, you love it, but you hate it. Like, you're thinking about it. It's just like, yeah, I had some good times with you, but I think it's time you have to... It's like an ex-girlfriend. It's like, I had good times with you, but I think I have to let you go and just kind of move on. Like, I want it, but I don't. It's just like that. It's like, you'd like those games, you'd want to play them again, but it's like, come on. I'm ready to just go now. I'm ready to just go. And like...
60 frames, Anthony. Higher resolution.
Oh my god. It's just it
better contrast.
You can actually see totally the design justified. In their fingers now. Look,
$49.99 plus tax.
That's great.
$59.99.
Hey, you know
if you're
what? If they did like 5 and 6 for like $20, that'd be great.
What they should do is remake Sweet Home.
That'd be kind of cool, actually.
I mean, like, just a full-on...
Or Resident Evil, because that's what it is.
Sweet Home came first, so Resident Evil should be called Sweet Home.
That's what I meant to say.
Sweet Home Revelations 2. That's what the title should be.
It should be called Resident Evil Sweet Home.
Sweet Home. But, the Sweet Home Chronicles.
But the problem with, like, this is, like... I could probably see them doing that, to be honest, but like, which is sad, which is really sad. But again, it's just, like I said, I'd be buying it while just jamming my middle finger in their face. Like, fuck, man, stop. Like, just stop. Like, I can't, like, it's just, you just don't want it. You want it because it's like, they're good games, man. Like, I get to play co-op. I don't got to fucking hook up my old consoles like that. But that's why I got them on PC. Because I could play RE4 Mercs. I could play RE4. I could just fucking play, like, you know, like, RE4 got released last year again in the whole Ultimate thing. And, like, that was cool. Like, $20, not bad. It was $11 on Steam. It is right now. Go pick it up. I recommend it. RE5, got it because it looks great. I don't got to hook up my 360, and I have RE6. So I got the other trilogy, and I'm going to have Remake on PC. Do I get these? Now, I got them on sale. Remake, I want to, like, support. Because it's great.
Yeah.
It's great to have. But, it's just, like, as far as them, like, re-releasing another release again, I don't know. I really just want them to just stop after Revelations 2... Or at least give us something of a new, like, direct sequel. Nothing else. Like, I don't...
Well, we'll probably get the Revelations double pack in HD.
Fucking God. They shouldn't even do that.
With Revelations 1 and 2.
You can't even make one look better than it already is. You'll still run at 30 frames because they're just too lazy to fucking go back and fix it to make it look 60. Like, if this one isn't going to be fucking 60 frames, which who knows... I don't know. I think that... Because it's just like you have RE4. It's like the best-selling survival horror game of all time.
Oh.
And it's just like, what went wrong? Like, what happened? I don't know.
I remember Angry Joe said in his Call of Duty review that, in his opinion, Call of Duty is becoming like a lion at the end of its lifespan. Like a proud creature that's dying.
Yeah.
I don't agree with that because Advanced Warfare was great. But I can see that with Resident Evil. It's like this used to be the king of the jungle. And now it's just limping.
But it's like, it even says right here, while working on The Last of Us, Naughty Dog took cues from Resident Evil 4 on the attention and
yeah.
It's just like... You... They,
even Naughty Dog
Naughty
took
Dog
notice.
Took note, and then you said at one point that you're taking note from games like The Last of Us. What kind of ass backwards approach of that is that? Like, what the fuck?
What kind of assholes are you to say that and then come out with Revelations 2? Does that look anything like Last of Us or Tomb Raider?
Well, that's why I'm just hoping that this next game is something that...
I feel like we say that, like, in every podcast.
Do you think we're jinxing it? We keep pushing it back, and it's just...
I feel like we're always saying how we have hope for the series, but then each installment kind of, like, negates what we're saying.
This is the thing, though. To be fair, when we started this podcast, the latest release since this podcast has been up... And running since day one, episode one, is fucking Revelations, for Christ's sake. We literally haven't gotten anything in this whole lifespan that's new. This is the first thing that's, like, new.
Well,
and I'm not talking about Biohazard Remastered.
But here's what I'm saying. It's like a year ago when we read that article where, you know, Capcom was like, we're looking at games like Last of Us and Tomb Raider, you know, you and I were like, oh shit, like, this has to be good. Tomb Raider and Last of Us kind of have that same gritty survival feeling to them. Mm. There's a common element to
those
games.
And we haven't seen anything since, though, like main titles.
And what have we seen since then? We've seen Remake Remastered, and we've seen Revelations 2.
But I mean, from our main perspective, it's just like, in those...
From, like, a main installment perspective, we haven't gotten anything since 6.
And it's just, like, in general, it's like, Remake Remastered was, like, announced in September. This was officially announced in, like, September. Or, like, October-ish. Like, it's just, like... during this podcast, I can't believe that. The only thing that was fucking released was Revelations. It's just us making predictions and hoping and that's fine, because, like, people want to hear us, obviously, because the last fucking episode got over 1,000 fucking views. It climbed faster than any other of the episodes that we made.
I think it was because of the comments.
And, like, yeah, that too. And it's just like, hey, I love you guys for that.
Oh, shit.
But people like hearing us talk about it, because who else is fucking here talking about Resident Evil? I mean, and that's fine. But, like, it's good that we make predictions, because we don't really, like, have any expectations, because they are lowered, because we know how they operate. All we could do is just kind of discuss it and kind of make sense of maybe what they could possibly be doing. It's like, we read those articles, yeah, we're getting, like, as far as, like, something new in the series, and I'm not going to count Remake. We're getting Revelations 2, but it's just like... What if this was just kind of like a side thing that, like, they kind of had, but they weren't sure if they're going to release, and then they just kind of decided to do it, like, and then it's like you got this main installment that could be good. I don't know. Or you might have nothing at all, and we're just wasting our time waiting. I don't know. You know, I guess it has to count for something. I don't know. But that's why I think it's cool, because, like, we definitely want to hear from you guys down below on what you think is going to happen with Revelations 2. What do you think about the TV show? What do you think about the future of the series? I'm not going to say it's hopeless. I'm not going to say all hope is gone. But I'm just going to say I just really wish they just would stop with this thing that is spin-off, or just ports. It's like, Jesus Christ, man. And it's not like they released that many. It's just like, even the last couple, like Raccoon City and Revelations, it was just like, eh. And it's like, clock is ticking, and we are waiting, and you are doing what? I don't know. I guess we're...
They have to be doing something.
They have to be doing something, and we don't know. I guess we'll find out next year. I mean, I don't know. Maybe we'll get a trailer.
What did Naughty Dog do? They divided their team into two sets of people, or two groups of people, and they created two AAA exclusives. They made Uncharted 3, and they made Last
Perfect
of Us.
Games. They're great.
What did Capcom do? Revelations. Revelations 2. Remake Remastered.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's just like, man.
I mean, if Naughty Dog can do two AAA games within 4 years...
A company that actually looked at one of your games for inspiration?
These are people who made games about an orange cat jumping up and down. Collecting peaches.
A bandicoot. Like...
A bandicoot.
These are things that...
The fuck is a bandicoot?
They exist.
Dude. Bandicoots must be like ocelots.
Definitely.
Yeah. Oh, okay. That's... Yeah. Okay, that looks nothing like Crash.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. But...
I've seen bandicoots before.
But right? And Jak and Daxter, too. Great. Those are good games.
Oh, you bandicoot, you adorable. Damn. You get the little bandicoot.
You sound sad. Have some sparkling cider.
Did you know I didn't even know the ocelot was an animal?
Really?
Until after I played it. Yeah, I was like, I was like, that's cool. I wonder what Ocelot, and then it's a cat. I'm like,
fuck.
Oh. So it wasn't just a name creation for the game.
So, I mean, I don't know. I guess all in all, I guess we're just going to have to wait it out, be patient. And I guess just look forward to Remake, I guess, in January.
Let's just give 10 minutes for cue the music.
Oh, God. Here we go.
The shitty YouTube comments.
I gotta mark this down. 2 hours and 15 minutes it is. Alright, cue the music now. Oh, God. Wait. What video is this? I have to find this because I have to read them with you.
This is the opening cinematic on the official.
You can start. I'm gonna get there.
Alright. Bish Almooch Turi says, they change her voice. They change everything about her. I feel like I don't know her anymore. Happy frowny face.
Like it's a real life drama.
Yeah. Gameplay better than graphics. People complaining about the graphics, fuck off. I still play RE1. And it's 1,000 times better than RE5 or 6, even with the dated graphics. Spoken by John J. Rambo. Well, to that I would say that RE1 was a product of the time. So for 1996, RE1 looked amazing. You know? For 2015, does Revelations 2 look amazing? No. Shayel says... So happy to see Claire again. Oh yeah, I forgot about the replies. The replies have sometimes they're the best.
They are. Let's see.
Claire, what's happened with your face? Surprise face.
This guy, George Lepropoulos. Ugh, I hate English dubs. I just can't stand how the lips are always off. It can't be helped. Obviously, which is one more reason to keep the original Japanese... There was never fucking original Japanese voices. They record all Resident Evil... this isn't the comment, by the way. This is me. They record all Resident Evils in English, from what I understand. So, yeah, whatever. He said, not to mention they sound better. A few video game voice actors actually sound decent. On another note, the game looks amazing. I really can't wait.
I really disagree with that comment. Yes. Few video game voice actors, Anthony. Mm. I could give you a whole fucking list of voice actors who do a great job.
Mm.
Scumbag Fazzy says, Claire's booty looks amazing. Mm. That's also important. This game...
Gotta have that video game butt.
Not like it makes
this
a
guy,
difference when it looks like a budget
guy,
title.
Paramore BNE5. Claire faces little ugly and weird. Frowny face.
Yeah. I agree with that.
Darth Q-Ball says, why change her voice? I don't mind that she looks older, but her voice fit her character.
I agree with that, but the way that he words it
Little
is pretty
funny. Little Big Planet 667, questionable animation, but still, I'm looking forward to it.
Wizard Lockhart 1012. People who hate Claire's new voice look. She's not a vampire. She's a human. Humans age. Age increase leads to voice change. Simple.
Somebody, 13324.
So your face completely changes and becomes deformed when you reach your 30s.
Somebody, 13324, says, her voice changed. We're used to RE2, RE Code Veronica voice actress, but hey, it's not actually bad. I look forward to this game. It's going to be epic, I hope. Oh,
nope.
This is the best one. Desmond Torrance. This better have Alex Wesker in it or I'll be pissed.
I think he's done.
This one. Ryu X Jury. Fucking Barry, you fuck your papa.
Fucking Barry, you fuck your papa.
He said, fucking Barry, you fuck your papa. No punctuation, nothing. I don't know.
What does that
mean? I don't know. Oh my god.
Rob's gaming channel. Nope, not liking Claire's new voice. And I don't have a problem with the graphics, but the facial animations are weird as hell.
This guy said,
man.
Moss, M-O-S, Code Veronica copycat intro, almost.
What?
It's nothing like Code Veronica's intro.
So, a girl invading a facility in Paris.
And a cheesy TV commercial also. Keep that in mind.
Getting captured by security guards is the same as being abducted at a party.
That's the same.
Man, the fanbase of Resident Evil is a cancer. Just realized after reading the comments of the hookers who complained. who complain about the graphics and voice acting. Shit. The gameplay is what really matters. Stop complaining, please. This cinematic is kind of cheesy, though. But this is one of the reasons why people love RE since 1996.
This guy, Abdullah Hamada. Claire face remind me of Madonna face. T-T face.
Great game. So when it's coming to PS2?
This Ryan 215553. Everything in slow mo, M-O-E.
M-O-E.
2007 called. It's asking for its graphics back. Jaxie.
Greg Heff 0511 says, I'm not one for someone who would enjoy great graphics. We kind of need to remember people. Capcom is up to its neck and going out of business. I'm sure the game is going to be fun, which is why I'm giving them my support.
Mr. So Young says, Claire looked like Indian. No, get this. Claire looked like Indian, parentheses, Asia. So there you go.
I still don't understand why Capcom changed the voice of Claire. I mean, no offense, but the new voice just doesn't fit to Claire at all for me. Allison Corr will always be the number one and only Claire Redfield because her voice is just completely amazing, very recognizable and iconic, and most of all, she has a perfect sexy voice for Claire. But what the heck? I'm still looking forward to this game. I better hope that the game will have some survival horror feeling to it, because if not, then shit will hit the fan. You better not disappoint us this time, Capcom. This is your...
What?
To prove your worth, make this game one of the best RE games ever, okay? Since you've brought Claire Redfield back in the house.
You brought her back in the house, yo!
It also made Barry Burton finally a playable main character since Barry has been away since a sidekick in RA1. It's about damn time that Barry should be a playable main character since we love and miss Barry so much. It's not only the voice. They made her ugly as fuck.
This guy, actually, Julian Taylor, and I don't know if this is true. What the fuck? Shinji Mikami is listed as level designer? Is that true?
I don't know.
That's interesting. I guess we're going to have to look into that. The Generation Artstorm. This animation remind me of old games such as Final Fantasy IX or maybe Obscure series. The only that catch my eyes are the lips. Looks weird, but I hope gameplay will be better than the most of RE5-6. This one also doesn't fucking make any sense because this... I don't know. This guy, Robinson Edgar, says, holy crap, Resident Evil characters having an actual conversation. My mind is blown. Like, what the fuck? Like, you've never seen Resident Evil characters have a conversation? Like, story-related?
You've never played any Resident Evil game before?
You haven't played fucking anything? Like...
They've destroyed Claire's beautiful face, just like they did with Jill. The idiots have give both hotnesses giant noses.
What the fuck?
Actually, Julia Voth had a bigger nose than the girl in Revelations, and she's still a lot hotter, so... I don't know. Unapologetically, Kenny says, "They are not sexual objects. That's why they made it ugly, so you can't fap with it." Tough shit. Tough shit for you, kid.
You can't fap with it.
That's why they made it ugly, so you can't fap with it.
Remember, kids, you can't fap with it. These are virtual characters.
And then another comment says, this is a replying to that comment, "I don't even understand how she is ugly. I bet those people don't look as good as this fake computer character called Claire. Correct me if I'm wrong. And indeed, no one will fap with it."
Richard, can you fap with it?
Okay. Yeah. I can fap with
exactly.
anything.
So, what is their problem?
If you're a 14-year-old boy playing Resident Evil, odds are video games in general, you're gonna fap to video game characters.
The problem is that why are these guys acting like it's so serious? Like,
wait. This looks amazing. Anyone who complains is a liar, because if you like modern RE or classic RE, you'll like this.
You'll like it.
Number one, Claire's voice is totally wrong. If you're going to replace her other actress, at least get someone who sounds like her. Number two, her nose, skin color, and overall appearance is inconsistent with her prior iterations. Has she had plastic surgery? Number three, animations look stiff and odd. And number four, the voices don't contrast well with the actions and movements, giving the appearance of a badly dubbed Asian movie. Holy shit, I think I agree with all of those points.
David Curry says, "Why is Dante from DMC in a Resident Evil game? Does this mean they share the same universe now? What the fuck is he talking about? Dante's not in this fucking game."
Everything wrong with Revelations 2 opening cinematic. 6 seconds. "What if fine? The fuck are you, a doctor?" 18 seconds. "I was going to say Obama." 40 seconds. "What took them so long?" 49 seconds. "Those fucking guys' smiles." 1 minute and 10 seconds. "Discount Allison Court." Also, Allison Court wasn't hired to do Claire's Redfield voice. To do Claire Redfield's voice in this game, I guess because people can't always have the same voice when you get older. He pointed out so many. "Moira is a dick to Barry. What a bitch." "Dramatic slow motion to support Zack Snyder." "Those three shots could have gotten Claire and Moira by now. They somehow didn't get cuts from the broken shredded glass window." "Game censors the word whore." "One long year of pretending of being friends." Claire Redfield isn't wearing anything red in this game. Isn't her jacket...
Is it red?
It's a shade of red.
It's fucking red.
Ugh, I hate English dubs. I just can't stand how the lips are always off.
Can't XWXS2. Graphics! Hold on. Graphics! Suck!
Oh.
Because he's very upset about that. And then the reply says, "So does your mom." If you know what I mean.
Capcom made Claire look so ugly. On the Degeneration CGI movie, she looked fine. Why all the alterations? If this is Capcom's way of making her look older, she sure doesn't age well.
Capcom has money problems, so don't hate them for it. Don Cavini is very confused. "Thus is PS3 version, right?" So, I think we need to direct him that this is a scene that will look the same on whatever you play.
I think we need to direct him to the trailer. That way you can see the consoles at the end.
Skagger24 says, "What the fuck am I watching? This looks like..."
Oh, I see it.
Oh, you see it? This looks like Beyond Two Souls. Not fucking Resident Evil. I miss the old RE games. The shit Capcom puts out these days are trash.
And right above that, the Agony Audio XVNVX says, Moira looks like Jennifer White. Jennifer White.
He's just fat to that.
Who is a porn actress, if you didn't know.
I did not know that.
Say hello to your friends, Babysitter's Club. Those is PS3 version. Claire's face is little ugly and weird. Frowny face.
Ugly and weird.
She's alright. She doesn't need to look like Sharon Stone in the 90s. All that's important is if the game is as scary as RE1 to 3.
Well, since it looks like we're running out of comments, let's go to the second trailer, which has Barry in it, I believe.
I was expecting Claire to be fucking ripped.
Yeah, go to the second trailer, because I ran out of comments on this one. It did end, so.
Alright, Revelation 2, second trailer.
Yeah, it's got PSRB. It by Resident Evil. They uploaded December 2nd, that one.
This is fucking all right. Amazing.
A guy named Horse. Wow.
Oh, dude! Gabberman!
He's back?
Gabberman's back! Ha ha! People were begging for Capcom to bring Barry back. Now he is back, and people still complain. This fan base is so ridiculous.
But he's ridiculous! Isn't that the whole point?
Barry is pretty ridiculous. I know, they are almost as bad as The Last of Us fans.
What the fuck? Isn't Gabberman... Wait.
The Resident Evil fan base is cancer, and then Gabberman said that we're almost as bad as Last of Us fans.
Gabberman is saying people are complaining about it, but he complained the last time we read his comments.
He complained about something. Yeah. I remember him.
Alright, well, this guy...
Fucking Gabberman.
This guy says, I'm pretty sick of... this Eric Cabrera... I'm pretty sure that if Capcom were to remake RE2 and 3, the rotten part of the fanbase would still be complaining because it doesn't have the same feeling, or it's not the same. Grow up!
J. Blue Ridge Sumihig says, you better don't fuck this up, Capcom, because Evil Within beat your Resident Evil's ass. Oh, one of my subscribers replied to that. Evil Within began and was amazing for about 8 hours. Then you have the insane Dragon Ball Z fight with the Anpods. Shinji Mikami has lost the plot. He got carried away with action in RE4, and now with Evil Within. Evil Within was pretty disappointing. A major Resident Evil ripoff that was handled poorly.
This
what the
fuck? Here we go. Carl Smith says, I'm happy to see Barry, but... The fuck? He looks... he looks different, but in the wrong way. What?
Is there a right way?
Is there a right way to get older, Richard? Like, to look older? Because he's already...
If you look different, is there a right way, or... Wow, Capcom really trying to copy off The Last of Us. Young girl plus old dad. Seriously, Resident Evil never used a 50-year-old protagonist ever. Barry was just a sidekick until they saw the success The Last of Us had. It shows how truly desperate they are to emulate other games. Just exactly how they admitted to copy COD's success by forcing their main Resident Evil series to be more action-paced.
Uh-oh. Ryan215553 is back. I bet the little girl's Barry's other daughter that died by a gun. That's why Moria won't use. That's why Moria won't use firearms. No, she's not. Her name's Natalia Korda, and didn't shoot Polly, her sister. Okay. George, some whatever. I prefer the original Barry's face. This one looks like a character of another game with the name Barry Burton. What?
Just when I think Capcom couldn't be any dumber. They go and do something like this and totally ruin Barry Burton. We asked for Barry and we received some other guy? This is a shame. Since 4, the RE franchise has gone downhill. And for all of you rail-shooting, Call of Duty-loving, infinite ammo-craving, no-puzzle-having, Michael Biggs... Michael May exploding, upgrade everything, enemy dropping items.
No shit. This guy is fucking pissed.
Again, no challenge involved. 6 different storyline with no real answer. Loving you, Jen. Fanboy girls.
What the fuck?
You must not have played the originals. You're so stuck on Halo, Call of Duty, and Gears of War. Have you even played the originals? If you have, congrats. I'll let the RE5-6 reviews speak for themselves. Oh my god, he just kept going on and...
No good! Zoom's just like, what the fuck?
It just
okay, this comment. Khaled Nazor. This exactly like Silent Hill.
No!
No, it's not!
Do you see anything supernatural about this trailer?
Alright, this one.
Oh.
Okay. Frank Mula. Seems like Capcom is trying to take a page from Silent Hill 1's playbook. Not surprised they're trying to milk the cow out of the Revelation spinoff.
Jesus Christ, look at all these negative Nellies over here. I don't care. Barry's back. And that's all I wanted from this game.
That's it. Nothing else.
Just
they could put him in like the main menu, he's back, and then that's it.
So does this mean you think RE5 is the most amazing game ever made? Because Barry's
in the Mercs reunion.
Yeah. The shitty part is Capcom is keeping a lid on the fact that they've completely ruined Claire Redfield by recasting her voice actress. Now she sounds generic as hell. Fuck Capcom. I'll torrent this game way before I even think about buying it.
This Manny C. DeVillain. Resident Evil 4 on GameCube was the best. The rest sucked balls.
Richard Valentine says, fuck yes. And the people complaining about Barry having a machine gun are idiots. If you ever have a daughter that got kidnapped, go save her with a shitty handgun.
He's trying to really justify that. It's a fucking video game.
Barry was prepared and wanted to take care of business. So of course he is going to have a machine gun and a magnum. And maybe his campaign will have limited billeted because Revelations 2 brings back survival horror. I think he tried to say bullets, but it says billeted. And Claire's campaign is going to rock. She starts off with nothing and has to scavenge her weapons.
Jake Mueller says, one day, Resident Evil will become a first-person shooter like COD, but who gives a fuck? Barry's back. Lol.
You know what would be perfect? You know what would be a perfect RE7 game? Chapter settings. RE6. 4-story campaigns is perfect. Like Leon mode, Adam mode, Chris mode, and Jake.
They're not modes.
Would be awesome.
Yo, I played Ada mode. That shit is fucking awesome.
Graphics and gameplay. A mix of our report.
Oh, God.
Yo, I played Sebastian mode and evil with it.
Yo, I like the part. I like the DLC where it's Kidman mode. That's my favorite.
I like the other
Yo,
DLC
Last of Us.
Where you play as Boxman mode.
And Last of Us, I like Ellie mode. Oh, God.
In Call of Duty, I like Troy Baker mode. A mix of RE4 and RE5, but with better texture details. Something next-gen-ish, but not too much action like RE6. Upgrading system. RE4. With more guns. More upgrading options. Enemies. Enemies who can't shoot. Throw grenades. Or fly fucking helicopters. Enemies like the T-103 Tyrant. Chainsaw from RE4. The tribe zombies from RE5. Even though they did throw things. The mini-bosses from the Evil Within game. You know, your typical survival horror zombies. The shoot-and-run technique with a shoddy. Just imagine a game like this.
This is the best one, though. Agus Blackwood.
Oh, God.
I want it! I want it! Like, it's in all caps. Like, he's just spread eagle ready for it, man. He's fucking ready.
He's spread eagle, dude.
I've got this.
Barry Burton. Okay. Barry Burton. Haven't seen you since 1997. Shit. You're old as fuck now.
My God. Dick Jones says, no Wii U, no bye.
Resident Evil Revelations 2, second trailer. And it got 22 thumbs up. This actually looks scary, and it's a really good idea to be set in an insane asylum, even though it's a prison. After Resident Evil 6, I imagined a Resident Evil game with Claire Redfield and Barry Burton as protagonists. It would have taken place in a medieval castle, and now I am shitting my pants on the fact that I got main protagonists right. If this was set in a castle, I would have just had a heart attack.
Marion gameplay. Looks good, trailer. I love Resident Evil. Stop to my channel that I have a guide. The first Resident Evil to play full one. So, if you want a guide to Resident Evil first one...
Do you speak English?
Will Martinez says, the voice actor that plays Barry sounds like Liam Neeson. This is going to be badass.
Pyro Sir Brad says, I like it. I always loved Barry due to him being the only guy who is classified to do this. Not some young guy who knows how to use knives, or another young guy who is built like a rock. Just Barry. And I like how he had to... And I like how to age him well since the 1998.
since the 1998.
Which I think this game takes place in 2011. And the only thing that is keeping him strong and able to pull through an age of 50 is the fact that his daughter is missing and he wants her back. Just seeing an old, withered, tired, depressed Barry fight monsters just to know if his daughter is alive not only sort of brings a tear to my eye, but interests me to the point where I want to pre-order this game.
Yo, Richard, remember when Resident Evil 3 came out in the 1999? Do you remember that?
No, but I remember when Resident Evil 5 came out in the 2009.
Oh my God. Hey, look at this guy. This isn't even true. What? Unless he does play Barry, I don't think so. Moin Saeed says, Troy Baker again? FFS. Can developers not afford anyone else? With an increase in demand, has Troy Baker lowered his rates or something? Tried hiring this voice. That's...
Troy Baker is not even
in. That's not
game.
Him, is it? That's not Troy Baker. That can't be.
Who? Barry?
That's who he's talking about.
No, Barry is the guy from Remake who also did Barry.
So, well, I guess this guy knows all because, I mean, once he hears Troy Baker, I mean, it's fucking Troy Baker because he said so.
I don't complain about Barry. The second I saw a man with a beard and the word father, I remember the Barry.
I want to note that a lot of people are spelling his name like a berry, like from a tree.
I remember the berry, since he betrayed Jill and Chris and everyone for his family. Also saved them because he is a good people.
That's terrible.
When I first saw the man with a gun in a helicopter, I thought he is Chris, but now another START member.
START member. Another START.
It very great. Just like the old time.
What is he, Japanese? This guy says, Jepic says, Barry looks like Japanese now. So, there you go.
I prefer the original Barry's face. Oh, you read that one. Chris, Leon, Sherry, and Ada all came back in Resident Evil 6. Claire and Barry will both return in this game. What about Rebecca?
Death Chris 2000 says, yeah, Barry is back, but the new face kind of looks gentle, I think. It looks like an Asian.
Dude, okay. The code name Death says, I am talk about the plot. Because there's so much bullshit within the comments section. Claire Redfield and Moira was taken by a known group and place within Island that is infested with B.O.W. They need to do whatever take to survive the situation. Now Barry whom discover that his daughter was kidnapped.
Fuck these people. Fuck. God damn.
And brought into that island. He gonna have some time, take any weapons, since he gonna try rescue his daughter. Makes sense why he carry machine gun, while Claire never had any time prepare herself. Anyone whom complain about Barry carry machine gun, then I ask you, this survival horror fanboys, if that was your daughter taken in an island with many monsters, would you be smart and carry many type guns and ammo as you can? Or be dumbass and carry a little handgun with less
ammo. Oh my god. Oh lord. Oh. I think I had enough of comment reading. Unless you have any more you wanna
Who is the little girl at the end? I can't wait. Intel. It's a full game, then I'll buy it. Oh, until he said Intel. Like intelligent. Oh my god. None of this episode BS, so could you please tell me when it's a full game, although that'll probably be a while away. Oh well, it gives me an excuse, other than being a lazy fuck who doesn't want to switch between consoles just to record a Let's Play, to hold on to my 360 for a while. That way the price for the Xbox One would have dropped, and I would have played through my games and recorded most of them. So what I'm trying to say is this will probably be the last game I'll buy for the Xbox 360. How the time flies.
That's a good comment about the game, actually, so. He just told us our
PC version coming out. PC Master Race.
Oh, fucking god.
Fucking Master Race comments.
Biggest dicks. Well,
I am so tired of people talking shit about Resident Evil, about RE/ORC was crap and RE6 wasn't what fans wanted. Now they are saying bad things about this game and it didn't even come out yet. I will always be a diehard Resident Evil fan. I played everyone and beat them and loved them. So please, just stop playing them if you don't like the games anymore.
Well, that's kind of true. I mean, as far as like this last part where it's just like if you don't like them at all, like just stop complaining. Like,
yeah.
If they're not forcing you to fucking play this.
But then again, like, if you complain about Raccoon City and 6, there's no reason why you shouldn't complain about another game that looks bad. Yeah, Barry Burton is back in this game. He's shaping up to be good. Two characters that haven't been in a Resident Evil game in ages. Now we just need Rebecca Chambers, Billy Cohen, Carlos Oliveira, and Hunk. Could the girl at the end of the trailer be Polly?
God damn it, I fucking hate these people.
I'm glad Barry not end up like Chris in Code Veronica, you know, coming with full gear and lost it instantly. Screw Resident Evil. The Evil Within is the new king of survival horror. This series was ruined when they started catering to Call of Duty fanboys. Oh, Silent Hill is good too.
No, it's not.
I feel like the longer ones are always funny because they go like
they
really
go into it or they can't spell.
I almost feel bad for Barry, to be honest. Until, of course, I quickly remember he's just a video game character, of course. But he's sort of become the Chuck Norris of the Resident Evil franchise. Liked for reasons that were completely unintended and have nothing to do with the actual character himself. Everyone just remembers him for silly quotes, due to poor dialogue choices, that just so happened to catch on as a meme. And now all of a sudden, he's this character everyone loves, despite the fact that he's only ever truly been in one game, where you don't even see that much of him anyway, because besides the odd pop-up from time to time to help you out. He's sort of like the guy that no one actually cares about, they just want to hear quotes from him. Who are you to decide what everyone thinks? I actually cared for his character and what has happened to his family. I've never understood why a lot of people think he's cheesy lines. He's heavily underused, and should have made a comeback way earlier. I agree with you. I want to stop, but I know there's at least one more comment that can give us a laugh.
Yeah, we have to find this last one.
What a mansion. Barry looks a lot more Asian than he used to.
They keep saying that. Forgive me.
I think my favorite one was the one who just kept going on and on.
I swear to God, if you do this shit again.
You Michael Bay exploding. Gun upgrading.
You do-gooder. You motherfucker.
Barry, yes, I want that Steve Burnside back too. I know he's alive.
Oh my God.
The Last of Us 2?
What?
I don't know. Barry is now Asian or something? I think he have Botox.
What the fuck? Okay.
Please, for Wii U.
Trying to find one, man.
Creepy crying nose. The trailer was really amazing, and so does the graphic. Look, bit. Look very Capcom game. I can't wait to play this game. There's just one thing, make me feel very funny. Barry's outfit. I think Capcom should take more good care of the costume design, because he look exactly like a teddy bear.
What?
Or Mario.
What?
Or Mario in that red sweater.
The red sweater. The red sweater. Oh, God.
I don't mind Capcom change his face. Obviously, he was very old in this time. However, Resident Evil always make a big brand about Survivor game, so at least give him something look stronger as a hero, time by time. Not look an old teddy bear or Mario in red sweater with a gun.
Oh, God.
The red sweater.
The red sweater.
That's the new inside joke.
That's it, dude. That's it. It's an insider with us and the fans.
Yeah, anyone listening to this podcast, this sweeter. You're in on it. There's no escaping.
I'm so happy.
So wait, is anyone from the first Revelations even in this game? I was hoping RE2... would involve Claire and all the new characters introduced in the first game. So far, all I got is Claire. Barry and Moira are a nice bonus, but what about Parker, Jessica, and Raymond? There's gotta be another one, like the sweeter. Hunk is the villain of the game. Seems like Capcom is trying to take a page from Silent Hill 1's playbook. Not surprised they're trying to milk the cow out of the Revelation spin. Oh, you said that one, didn't you?
I was about to stop you, but...
They should have used the live-action Barry and model him in this game. Same goes to other games that bury in the first game. That is, that is live action, of course. Looks so better to be model in all of the games. he was blonde hair in the live action, but in the game, he happened to get brown hair. Same goes to Wesker in the first game. Brown hair, but live action Wesker have blonde hair. I don't make sense from how they made the game back then. That remind me of the live action Jill in the first RE. Looks just like the Jill in the game for real. And she looks cute. Bet she looks old today.
Danny Mo says, Barry looked more Caucasian back in 1998. Everyone looks fucking Asian. Yes. I do have a problem that, no, I'm not racist, yet I'm a Resident Evil purist. You can't appeal to a Western audience for nearly two decades and then flip.
You cannot trace me. You
and then flip everything on the fucking side. Just look at Leon and Degeneration. What the fuck? At least Capcom are still trying to make some effort by copying Shinji's Evil Within with Asian detectives everywhere.
Asian detectives.
He said Asian detectives everywhere.
Young Knockout says, if it's not on par with The Last of Us, then I'm not buying it.
Damn, you have high expectations for every fucking game. Because let me tell you, my friend, not every game is The Last of Us.
Oh, Mark Main.
Oh, wow.
All I need is Chris to make a cameo, and I'm completely hooked.
That sums it up right there. The zombie bub. I screamed like a bitch! I've never been this hype before. I can't decide whether to buy the first episode or release, and so on, or buy the full version a month later. Fuck! He's oh, mad.
Calm yourself.
This is...
My story goes after the mansion incident. He retired early to spend time with his family. Then after long civilian life, although he was discharged, cops working on security contractors after mansion, but he's still hanging after Albert Wesker used his family as hostage and blackmailed him to betray his team to save his family. He become close friends, contact after Leon Kennedy, involved in Raccoon City, and my sis, Claire.
Okay.
And his avatar is Chris Redfield sitting in a chair.
Dickhead. Alright, here we go.
I think.
Okay, this one. This might be a good shutout. Okay. Pain192. When did Revelations 1 and 2 take place? And what happened to Barry with an E? On Resident Evil 1, last time I saw Haim was when he saved Jill Sandwich and said Jill Sandwich. Also, when was Resident Evil 1 take place? How is this the first Revelations? What happened to Jill Sandwich? What happened to it?
How is this the first revelation?
Like, are you that fucking nuts?
They ask Barry, have it and now want to be changed. Seriously, they call themselves fans and not settle for anything. Pathetic most. Oh my fucking god, amazing. Cannot wait for this game. I never knew Barry Burton was Asian.
Oh, fucking god. Yes. The Musou Warrior, yes. Barry Burton is back. Even though I can't for the game, I can't wait for the physical version. Releasing games episodic is annoying, I think. Plus, I prefer physical over digital, so, eh.
I think Barry coming back is great and all, but please don't get me wrong. I'm not comparing Resident Evil movies to the games at all, but when he, spoilers, died in that awful movie, I figured Capcom was done with him. But I guess not probably, because of the fanbase. Rebecca being in Resident Evil. Okay, that's when I draw the line. Rebecca, how can I put this? People say she is badass and blah blah. Honestly, she needed a man to save her way too many times. I think Rebecca was cute, but like, do we really need her? Honestly, I prefer Claire over Rebecca. Unless Rebecca has changed into an actual hero, then sure. For Billy, what is he supposed to do? He is an escaped fugitive who supposedly died. Like, are you kidding me? The story ended with him finally set free, and I was okay with that. Then Sheva, my god. She is in the African branch of the BSAA. She will less likely show up. Only person that I am concerned for is Jill Valentine. Why? Because she was never mentioned in 6. I'm sure the traumatic events of 5 would cause Jill to develop as a character. I honestly hope Resident Evil Revelations is in the same year as RE6, because possibly Jill could show up. Not a huge gameplay. More like in a helicopter and saving Barry, Claire, and Moira, like how Barry saved her in Resident Evil 3. To all of the douches that want Leon, stop. Just stop. Like, Leon is too overplayed. I just want the Leon and Ada thing to end already. I blame all of the douches for even giving birth to Albert Wesker's son, because clearly, you all wanted it to be action, which turned into shit. RE4 was the start of its downfall. 5 was, oh hey, let's do the same thing but in Africa, and add even more action. Then 6, oh hey, let's make big explosions. Oh, let's add Leon Chris for the fanboys. Double douchiness.
Double douchiness. Oh, God. You know, I've been reading these for 40 minutes.
Why RE nowadays doesn't have the feeling of main character could die, no more struggle, and rush whenever the zombies arrive. Because the character is so much badass, the zombies all suddenly weak. Maybe you people should make the surviving weak, one not badass one.
That's probably the best one, actually.
Fuck yes, Barry. The Burton is back.
The Burton. Not just Barry, the fucking Burton.
Barry, Resident Evil fanboys be like, Barry look different. Claire's voice sounds different. Moira looks like Ellie from The Last of Us. This shit is like Code Veronica X. You can't really please them. Such a bunch of whiny babies. Meh, I just want to play this game and enjoy it.
Is that it for the comments?
Moira looks like Ellie, apparently. Oh, man.
Well,
anything that matched the sweeter?
I'm looking, but I just keep seeing the same ones I'm going over.
Yeah, they kind of lost their flair.
Stop the music. All right, we'll stop that.
Okay.
All right, so that's at the 336 mark. Got to put that in my phone real quick. Because I'm going to edit this. Well, damn. We are 3 hours and 36 minutes in.
Mm-hmm.
Holy shit. That was funny. I'm happy we decided to do this again, because people liked it last time, so. Oh, man. We got some good laughs, though.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was great. What happened to the sweeter?
But just take a look at these. No Wii U,
you know
no
buy. Next time, we should just, like, find, like a page ahead of time that, like, we know, like, we just read a couple, but not read all of them. We're like, all right, this looks like a honeypot of, like, good comments. And just, like, read them all. Have a segment.
Yeah.
Stupid, shitty comments about, like, the new remake coming out for the ports, something like that. That'd be funny.
Code Veronica all over again. And that's Liam Neeson voice! Oh, my God!
Jesus Christ. It's not Liam Neeson. I don't think Liam Neeson ever did a game, did he?
No, he did Fallout 3. Yeah, he was the dad in Fallout 3.
I can afford him.
Shut up. Give me my sweeter, bitch.
Did you
Michael Bay exploding, gun upgrading.
Gun upgrading.
Explosive weapon.
Sweeter getting fucking... Casual cash resident fan fucking upgrading, infinite ammo chomping, Gears of War playing. It just keeps building and building.
I have to read it again. It's just so amazing. And his name is Raymond Unterzuber. We asked for Barry and we received some other guy. This is a shame, since 4, the RE franchise has gone downhill. And for all of you rail shooting, Call of Duty loving, infinite ammo craving, no puzzle having, Michael Bay exploding, upgrade everything, enemy dropping items, no challenge involved, six different storyline with no real answer loving, loving new gen fanboy, fangirls.
He had to put the fangirls in.
You must not have played the originals.
It was just so mad. Avatar. He was just like you just see him at his keyboard, motherfuckers. Like,
I know. Like, it took him 3 hours to edit it.
Yep.
How do I sound real mad? That's.
Well, I guess that's a wrap for this episode.
Yep, that's a wrap.
Well, thank God, thank you guys for listening.
If you made it this far.
Which you guys usually do, so... I think this is the second longest show that we've done, so it's awesome. You guys deserved it, because we've been away for a little while, so we're going to come back in about a month, talking about Remake or any other news that might come out between now and then. So thank you guys. I hope you guys are able to download this MP3 or whatever. Just stay tuned for just more streams, podcasts, and if you could follow me on Twitter, link will be in the description. If you want to stay updated for like streams and shit, I just post stuff about YouTube there, so you know what's going on. Or follow me on Twitch, JillSandwich9988. You could, again, I think there's a link on my channel. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the podcast. I can't wait to upload this so you guys can check it out. Thanks for all the support. Stick with us. We'll be back shortly. In about a month, so that's good.
I have something to say before we end the podcast.
Good.
It was in this article that I read. I just have to read off of it. So let me find it. Okay. I almost have the article. Where is this?
I mean,
oh wait.
People are already happy enough that we did a live show, so it's okay.
Okay, I'm sorry for the wait, guys. I would just like to end the podcast
on a last note
with this. It wasn't an article.
Now they will gasp with amazement when you see Ugg invent the ultimate weapon.